in memory of their friend and teammate Jasper Howard. The Huskies have spent the last 13 days with heavy hearts after hearing the stunning news of Howard's tragic death, a fatal stabbing on campus just hours after their homecoming victory over Louisville. Today, the sadness remains, but the Huskies hope to alleviate some of their pain by honoring their fallen teammate with a victory over Rutgers. In this, their first home game since losing number six, their friend and teammate known as Jazz. This afternoon, the UConn Huskies return home to Rentschler Field to reunite with the Husky Nation as they pay tribute to Jasper Howard. It's the Huskies of UConn against the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. Hi, everybody. Along with former Pitt quarterback John Congemi, I'm Mike Gleason. As always, great to have you with us here for the Big East Network Game of the Week. Now, a football game is always about wins and losses, but there's so much more inside the stadium. UConn wants to honor their fallen teammate, and they hope to do it with a victory. Now, John, yesterday you spent time at the football facility. Did you feel any sense of normalcy with the football team?
Well, yeah, I think there was some closure, Mike. You know, with the presence of them going to Miami for the funeral on Monday, they get back to stores. I think the practice times were the same. The lunch schedule was the same. Their meeting times were the same. They go back to class. So I think there was a sense of closure talking with everybody yesterday.
Well, the healing process, day by day, deeper and deeper. Yesterday, or actually last week, the healing process got a big boost from West Virginia fans, of all people. One banner really defined the afternoon when they said, "Today we are all Huskies."
It was an amazing embrace by head coach Bill Stewart and the Mountaineer family, their fans and teammates. They did a great job of welcoming UConn. And, you know, the emotion of coming to the field, Randy Etzel thought about taking the ball, but he ended up kicking off and then a 98-yard touchdown return. But they kept fighting back. That was what he was most proud of, extremely proud of the way they would take the lead a couple times in that game with an 88-yard touchdown reception there by Marcus Easley. But late in the fourth quarter, they tried to hold on for an emotional victory, but Noel Devine and that 56-yard touchdown run late in the fourth quarter really led them to their four-point victory. And, you know, it was a lot of emotion in that game, and they almost pulled out a huge victory.
Now for more on what's happening inside the stadium here this afternoon, let's check in with the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Quinn Kester.
Mike, it was a misty morning here in Hartford. Right now, the sun trying to burst through. Everywhere you look, you see number six on T-shirts, on jerseys, placards, and signs. Spent some time at the tailgate. It was a subdued tailgate. People not sure how to act. Student section was here early, an hour and a half before kickoff. They're here to show their support. They're here to grieve. They're here to cheer. They're here to move on. They will be a big part of the healing process.
All right, thanks a lot, Quince. Oh, so close last week, so far away. There was 2 minutes and 18 seconds remaining in the game when Jarrett Brown handed the ball to Noel Devine, and here come the Huskies back home. Moment of silence coming up here at Rentschler Field as the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers ready to take the field after the Huskies. You saw Andre Dixon holding the helmet of Jasper Howard, number 82. Kashif Moore holding the jersey of number 6. It was Kashif Moore, of course, who was holding Jasper Howard in his arms after the stabbing 2 weeks ago. Greg Schiano and the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers now ready to take the field here at Rentschler Field. Then a moment of silence. What's going through their mind, John, is the emotion obviously favoring the Huskies here today.
Well, for both teams, and when you're coming on the road in an emotional environment, you just want to be able to take care of what you can control. And that's, you know, offensively, try to protect the football, defensively, not make many mistakes. But emotions run wild because there's a lot of guys on that Rutgers team on their sideline from the state of Florida and South Florida that had a relationship with Jazz.
Well, these two schools, six of the last seven games they've played, the game's been decided by 10 points or less. Last year, of course, 12-10. Rutgers beating UConn in Piscataway. That opened up a seven-game winning streak to close out the regular season.
and hold up your number six card that you received while entering Rentschler Field today. On October 18th, 2009, the University of Connecticut community lost one of its own with the passing of football student athlete Jasper Howard. Jasper loved life, his family, football, and the University of Connecticut. He came to UConn from his native Miami and made an immediate impact on the store's campus. 2 weeks ago today, Jasper made 11 tackles and recovered a fumble as UConn defeated Louisville right here at Rentschler Field. We lost Jazz. Let us now have a moment of respect in memory of Jasper Tyrone Howard. Thank you.
A week ago, the Huskies went to Morgantown, came up short 28-24. This afternoon, they hope to honor number six Jasper Howard with a victory over Rutgers. Back to set up the game here at Rentschler Field right after this.
The Ohio State University.
The University of Texas.
Southern University.
California, Berkeley.
Old Dominion University.
Harvard University.
The University of Virginia.
Texas A&M.
Norfolk State University.
Georgia University.
Arizona State.
Pennsylvania State University.
The proud, the Marines.
What do you want, Haggardus?
I want to take Monday off for Chinchilla Day.
I've never heard of Chinchilla Day.
It commemorates the defenders of a tiny French village. Outnumbered and outsized, the courageous musketeers managed to defeat the badly behaved rogues.
How do you celebrate?
My people? Party in Vegas.
Welcome back inside Rentschler Field. The UConn Huskies getting ready to take on the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers, along with John Congemi, Mike Gleason here, Quinn Kesnick down on the field. You look at UConn, you think of the two-headed monster as far as running back, but Rutgers, they have a pretty good running game themselves.
They do. They love to control the football on the ground, and they have a young quarterback, so they have to do that. But Joe Martinick, he's got 7 touchdowns on the year. He's very consistent. He runs really hard between the tackles, and he's very tough to bring down. And he's very productive, Mike, deep into the game, into the fourth quarter. That's where he gets the most production out of his running ability.
You mentioned that young quarterback for Rutgers, Tom Savage. When he comes to the line of scrimmage, he'll be cognizant of number 9, Lindsey Whitten.
Yeah, he'll be on the edge, and that's a guy that really puts pressure on the quarterbacks. He has 10.5 sacks on the year, 11 tackles for loss, and he's second in the nation in sacks on an average with 1.5 per game. This is a guy who's setting up a terrific matchup with offensive tackle Anthony Davis today from Rutgers. It'll be a challenge for Lindsey, but he's got the power and the speed on the edge to make things happen.
All right, before we kick this football game off, let's check in with Quinn Kesnick, standing by with Randy Edsel.
Coach, what does it mean to be back home?
It means a lot. The warmth of our fans and to come in the Husky Walk, it comforts us.
What's one key to beating Rutgers today?
Well, we can't turn it over on offense. We've got to be able to stop the run on defense. We've got to take advantage of the opportunities that we have on special teams.
Thanks, Coach.
All righty.
All right, thanks, Quint. UConn won the toss. They deferred, so Rutgers will have the football first. And, John, you can't really pick up on it on the television screen, but coming into the stadium this morning, it was very, very windy. How will that play into the game today?
Well, I think it'll play into both sides, but, you know, both of these teams like to bloody their noses and really, really run the football in between the tackles. So with that wind, as you can see gusting from right to left, it's going to be very difficult in the kick game and very difficult to be accurate throwing the football. So you'd like to see both of these teams control the ball, control the line of scrimmage, Mike, will be the key for both offenses.
Number 13, Desi Cullen, the senior out of Louisville, Kentucky, getting ready to kick things off for the Huskies of UConn. And they said he did a remarkable job speaking to the team after the death of Jasper Howard. There's number 21, Devin McCourty. He's back deep with Joe LaFege, Here we go. This football game is almost underway. There's that blistery wind we talked about. It just blew the football off the tee.
Well, it's gusty normally in this stadium, but today especially that wind is picking up. But once it gets inside, Mike, it swirls from left to right and then back out the other side. So it's going to be a difficult day, you know, to catch the football, maybe field the football on punts and kickoff opportunities.
Last year, right here in this stadium, UConn lost to West Virginia. Robert Sands said, the safety for West Virginia, said Jasper Howard came up to him and said, nice game today, but next year we're going to get you. Well, obviously, Jasper never got the chance to go to Morgantown this year, and they fell short 28-24. Mentioned Noel Devine, 56-yard run with just 2:18 on the clock, and now trying to rectify that situation with a victory. There's the kick, and this one's going to Devin McCourty at the 2-yard line. McCourty over the 20. 40. Just like West Virginia a week ago, McCourty's going to the house. 98 yards for a touchdown. Rutgers is on the board. When you look at that UConn sideline, John, you have to be wondering what is going on.
Well, that's the decision head coach Randy Etzel made last week. He wasn't sure what he wanted to do, and he decided to kick off again at home, and McCourty just goes right up the middle. Terrific blocking by the special teams, and he makes one cut right there on the outside, and he's gone to the races, and he has enough speed to take it the distance for Rutgers to get on the board early.
A week ago, Tavon Austin for West Virginia went 98 to open the game, and now Devin McCourty goes 98 for Rutgers. Santee on for the extra point. Drills it through the middle. Santee now 23 for 23 on the year. And the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers opening up a 7-0 lead. First career kick return touchdown for Devin McCourty.
Well, just a nice job, first of all, fielding it and getting upfield. 98 yards on the return. He makes the cut right there, but on Desi Cullen, right there at the 30-yard line, he just puts on the jets and he's gone. Devin McCourty possesses great speed in that secondary, and he shows you some a flash of it on special teams there.
All you can say is, wow, if you're a Rutgers fan, Husky fan, just speechless. Greg Schiano now in his ninth year as the head coach of this football team. You look at what he did the first 50 games, 15-35. He's 36-11 over the next 54. And if they should win today, they come in at 5-2. They'd be 6-2, but they have to have 7 victories to get back to a bowl game because they had 2 Division I AA teams on the schedule this year.
The Rutgers fans making the trip from Piscataway. Off to a terrific start, and this is exactly what you said earlier. This is how the Huskies started on the road last week with that 98-yard kickoff return as well against them. So down 7-0. Randy Etzel last week said his team showed great resiliency trying to come back and getting the lead. Let's see if they can do that today.
Teddy Delagana with the kick. Robbie Fry at the 6. Fry finds a seam. There goes Fry. Cuts it back inside. Teddy Delagana, the kicker, brings him down inside the 45-yard line. So back-to-back weeks, Robbie Fry has a big kickoff return. This one goes for 50.
Well, they bounce right back on special teams and immediately get terrific field position on the Rutgers side of the 50-yard line. Just a nice job by Fry taking it up the middle. Again, watching that wall in front of him. He makes one cut to his right and then back to his left. And he gets the Huskies in terrific field position to start their opening offensive drive.
He tried the same move that Devin McCourty tried. It didn't work that time with Teddy Delagana. Out of the gun, Endress, first play from scrimmage now, swings it out. That's Todman inside the 35-yard line. Inside the 30, finally dropped at about the 26-yard line. A gain of 17 on the first play from scrimmage. Cody Endress, now number 2, John, in the Big East as far as passing.
He does a nice job. Last week at West Virginia in a loss, he had 378 yards on 25 completions, both career highs.
After the 17-yard gain, out of the gun again. Jordan Todman gets the call. Andre Dixon starting 2 weeks ago, starting last week against West Virginia. Todman gets the start for Randy Etzel this time. Devin McCourty making the stop defensively for Rutgers that time.
Well, Mike Todman was the guy that had the hot hand last week at Mountaineer against the Mountaineers. 20 rushes for 94 yards and a touchdown. He had a nice swing pass. He has 11 receptions, now 12 on the season on that first play.
Second and three for the Huskies. Little play action over the middle, and it's incomplete. He had his man open right over the middle, and it falls incomplete. That's Marcus Easley, who had that 88-yard touchdown reception last week. How about Easley, huh? Back-to-back-to-back 100-yard receiving games. And he was just put on scholarship this year, John.
Yeah, he was one of those guys that you find and you say, where's he been the last couple of seasons? The first Husky wide receiver to have three straight 100-yard games since Carl Bond did it back in 98.
Third and three for the Huskies. Endress fires. And they're going to call it incomplete. That was Kashif Moore. Great effort that time. The ball was thrown behind him. And if he had grabbed it, it would have been a fantastic catch.
Well, you come back to the play on second down where Cody Endress had Marcus Easley wide open over the middle. He didn't set his feet. He had no pressure. And on this play, the ball's behind. He's wide open in the flat. Is Kashif Moore. All he has to do is take a little bit off of it, make it a catchable ball, and Moore rolls past the first down marker.
Look close. Very good call by the officials, though, to touch the ground. This will be a 37-yard kick for David Teggart, who missed two field goals last week at West Virginia. Remember last year he opened up 11 for 11. And this one's good. So Devin McCarty opens the game with a 98-yard kickoff return, 7-0, but the Huskies come back after the 50-yard return by Robbie Fry. They answer with three, but Devin McCarty, his first kickoff return for a touchdown in his Scarlet Knight career.
What is it to lead? At PNC, it means building on a foundation of strength and stability. And now that National City is a part of PNC, it means that customers of both banks can look forward to greater possibilities than ever before. Together, we're even stronger. Together, we can do more. PNC, leading the way.
Fastest accelerating, most agile side-by-side in the world. The Red Hot Ranger Razor. Nothing else comes close. Razor sharp performance. See it up close at your local Polaris Ranger dealer.
I emailed you the list. Her plane just landed.
Go!
I need a rush order of 4 kids.
Thanks.
Excuse me, I'm looking for a dog bed.
What kind of dog?
Oh. This kind?
Nice job.
Oh.
Stay a step ahead on the nation's fastest 3G network.
Dude, just made out with Mariah Carey.
AT&T. Now get 50% off these Samsung touchscreen phones after mail-in rebate. Only from AT&T.
Let go.
Just let go.
Oh, to just let go.
Just let go.
Let's go.
Just let go for the fun. Just let go for the adventure. For the lazy and the crazy times where the ocean meets the sun.
In this sandy white oasis, no matter what your pace is, you can get away, while away, hide away, break away. Tradewinds Island is
a... Just let go.
Oh, come on, just let go.
You're right. So, truck month's almost over, and you know what that means, right? It's your last chance to save a lot of cash on built Ford Tough trucks. The number one trucks 32 years running. Hey, this is the original, the one and only, the real deal.
Now, climb behind the wheel of an 09 F-150 with up to $6,500 cash back or get 0% financing for 60 months plus $2,000 cash back. And Ford Credit is on board to help get you the financing you need. Time's running out to get the best deals. Truck month ends November 2nd, so see your Ford dealer today.
Welcome back to the Big East Network Game of the Week presented by PNC. 7-3 Rutgers on top of the Huskies of UConn. There you see the time remaining in the first quarter. 7-3, but UConn did answer the bell. That was very, very important, John.
Yeah, they needed to come back and answer that kickoff return by Devin McCourty. UConn had excellent field position. I thought they had an opportunity to maybe answer with 6 points, but Greg Schiano's defense did a nice job on second and third down to force Cody Endress into two incompletions, but yet they get the score back to 7-3.
So Greg Schiano sends his deep men back again, see if they could by Lightning twice. Back-to-back kickoffs. Jesse Collin with the kick. And this one's going to go out of bounds as Joe Lefez gives chase. And the penalty flag drops, and Rutgers will come back with some good field position. Tom Tomczyk, our referee of our Big East officiating crew here in Hartford this afternoon. You look at these two teams. I mean, I mentioned the fact that six of the last 7 years the game's been decided by 10 points or less, but this graphic really speaks volumes.
Yeah, the points so very close, points allowed as well, and then total offense. You can see both of these teams like to grind the football out. They like to hang their hat on their running game, especially when you have a young quarterback for Rutgers in Tom Savage. Now, this is a guy who's really fundamentally sound. He has a big, strong arm, and he's starting to recognize coverages, and I think he's getting more comfortable with his surroundings.
Savage under center to open things up for Rutgers. And he wants to put the first one in the air. Comes out firing. Has his man, the freshman, Mohamed Sanu. Sanu pulls in his 29th catch of the year. That one goes for 16.
Yeah, nice big target on the outside, freshman to freshman, and they've been doing this all season long. Sanu came in with 28 receptions on the year, make it 29, and between him and Tim Brown, they share the bulk of the receiving yards and the receptions for this Scarlet Knight offense.
Savage, 6'5", 230, true freshman out of Springfield, Pennsylvania. Play action, looking for the fullback, finds it. Corcoran driven out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Scott Lutris, the leader, back in the lineup today for the Huskies making the tackle. Let's take a look now at our impact players brought to you by the United States Marine Corps.
Well, Mike, I think up front's going to be a huge matchup. Anthony Davis, 6'6", 325. He has terrific feet. He'll be a great matchup against defensive end Lindsey Witten. And then Tim Brown, 32 receptions on the year and 3 touchdowns. Defensively, Ryan D'Amperio, 36 total tackles and 4 tackles for loss on the year.
Second and 6 for the Scarlet Knights. They keep it on the ground, and Martinick is immediately hit at the line of scrimmage. Coming up to make the initial contact, it looked like number 4, Twan Martin. You know, you look at that impact player, the impact players right after this play, John.
Yeah, nice job holding the line of scrimmage and moving that line of scrimmage behind Rutgers where they wanted to be was Twan Martin. He has 3.5 tackles for a loss. Add another one to that ledger.
Third and 7, Savage out of the shotgun this time. On the air, the Scarlet Knights hitting 36% in this situation. Twint trips to the top of your screen. Keep an eye on number 2, Tim Brown. He was very, very close to Jasper Holland. Savage standing there, and it's almost picked off. Number 48, Trevardo Williams, a true freshman, had his arms wrapped around his legs. But keep in mind, John, that Savage goes 6'5", 230 pounds. He wasn't going down.
He's tough to bring down, but a great athletic move on the outside by the true freshman from Bridgeport, Connecticut, Williams. You can see him come off the edge just with a burst of speed. And as you said, very difficult to take down Tom Savage at 6'5", but put a lot of pressure on the young quarterback.
Robert McClain standing back at his 10-yard line. And Delegano's kick will sail into the end zone. So the Huskies will have the football at the 20-yard line when we come back. 41-yard punt that time by Teddy Delegano.
Hey, Ham. What do you think the fine is for streaking?
Oh, I don't know. Like $300-$400?
Why?
You stink!
Sorry.
The more you save on insurance, the more you'll have football. Drivers who switched to Allstate saved an average of $396 a year. Are you in good hands?
Is it done yet?
No.
The Big East Network brings you more exciting college football action Saturday, November 7th, when Coach Steve Craigthorpe and the Louisville Cardinals fly over to Mountaineer Field to take on West Virginia and their dynamic running back, Noel Devine, a threat to go the distance on any given play. Can the Cardinals slow down and contain the Mountaineers' elusive 5'8 running back, or will Devine continue to evade defenders and propel his team to victory? All the action gets underway Saturday, November 7th at noon Eastern, only on the Big East Network.
A tour of duty.
Some headaches, bloody noses.
A harsh realization.
I get to coughing, and then I can't breathe.
A federal lawsuit.
I think it was there, and I think they knew about it.
WHAS 11's Melissa Swan investigates why these local guardsmen say it wasn't bullets or roadside bombs in Iraq that put them in the most danger.
We should have been informed.
Monday, beginning at 5 on WHAS 11 News.
Save big on your cell phone and internet service? Get Cricket. Right now, when you bundle Cricket's unlimited mobile broadband with an unlimited talk plan, it's just a flat rate of $65 total. Just call 1-800-395-9468 or click mycricket.com. $65 a month total for unlimited broadband and talk. Act now for this free USB modem and get a free month of service. Unlimited internet for your desktop or laptop on America's most affordable 3G network. With no contracts to sign and no overages, call, click, or come in today. Get respect for your wallet. Cricket.
Today's Big East Network game is brought to you by PNC, leading the way. And by Polaris, see the hardest working, smoothest riding off-road vehicle now at your local dealer. And welcome back to Hartford. The tailgaters were out in full force here today, and Mother Nature sending the winds out as well. These teams battling a stiff wind. Let's go downstairs and check with Quinn.
An unpredictable wind also. Gusts right now over 20 miles an hour. When this game started, the wind was blowing from right to left. It has since shifted. It's blowing from the UConn sideline over to the Rutgers sideline. Unpredictable and gusty. And keep in mind, Rensselaer Field used to sit on an airport. This is wide open terrain.
All right, thanks a lot, Quint. And now the Huskies starting from the 20-yard line. Andre Dixon in the backfield now behind Cody Endress. And Dixon gets his first carry of the afternoon. Not too much running room. Up over the line of scrimmage. A gain of two, maybe. Ryan D'Imperio making the stop for Rutgers. Now let's take a look at our impact players for UConn, brought to you by the United States Marine Corps.
Well, Andre Dixon, he's the guy just carrying the football. He's the workhorse. 7 touchdowns on the year. And Jordan Todman, he's the guy on the outside, catching the football out of the backfield, making it on the edge. He also has 7 touchdowns. And defensively, Lawrence Wilson leads the Big East in total tackles and an average of 11 per game.
Endress, little shovel pass. This is Jordan Todman looking for that seam. Found it. And he's up over the 40-yard line. He's rustled out of bounds by Zaire Kitchen. And a penalty flag is dropped after the tackle. And Todman goes 21 that time for the Huskies.
That's exactly what offensive coordinator Joe Moorhead.
Personal foul. Lady hit out of bounds. 29 on the defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
And Mike, what I was saying, offensive coordinator Joe Moorhead wanted to get Jordan Todman on the edge. He's the sweep guy that can set up a lot of things. It stretches this Rutgers defense from sideline to sideline. That opens up the vertical passing game. It opens up play action pass. They can do a lot. If they can create the edge and get the blocking on the edge, they'll be able to open up a lot in this offense today.
I was about to say you can't blame a defender, but that was a good call because Zaire Kitchen, they were a good 5-6 yards out of bounds when he threw him to the turf. Play action, Endress over the middle, has his man, he drops it. That was Ryan Griffin, the big tight end. And I'll tell you, JC, if he held onto the ball, it would have been a tough catch because the Scarlet Knights were all over him.
Well, he was going to take a shot down the middle of the field. That ball was not thrown with a lot of zip. It was just trying to fit the football in there. Cody Endress just trying to drop it over the linebacker. It's a perfectly thrown ball, but you have to catch it the first time. Anytime you bobble it over the middle, you're going to get a lot of attention. That time, the second hit really just jarred the ball.
Endress, 65% on the year, 3 straight incompleted pass now. For the Huskies, Dixon back into the lineup. This is Dixon with the call. Cuts it back, spins. And he's just inside the 40-yard line. As Steve Boharnes, the true freshman out of Saddlebrook, New Jersey, makes the initial contact.
Well, you can tell it's going to be difficult to run the football north and south. They have a balanced rushing attack with Dixon and Todman. You can see both have 7 touchdowns, very similar in yards. Total yards this season, but very difficult right now to run it north and south. They've had more success getting to the outside.
Dixon coming in had 17 more carries, 137. Jordan Todman with 120. Todman getting the start here this afternoon. Thought it was interesting yesterday. You were talking with Randy Edsall. We saw Dixon 2 weeks ago rush for 153. Last week it was Todman at West Virginia going for 94 on 20 carries. And he said, really, it's just a team effort.
is, and it's dictated by maybe the speed of the defense they're facing.
Endress looks left, comes back right, wide open. It's Kashif Moore. And Moore down by the 20-yard line. Might have stepped out of bounds at about the 23 or 24, but he picks up 17 on the play.
Mike, that's a nice job by Kashif Moore, really settling in the hole. The ball's delivered on time. Nice pass protection by the offensive line, but Kashif settles in the hole between the linebacker and the cornerback. He knew if he kept going to the outside, a headache was waiting around the 30-yard line, so he settles down just in the hole outside the corner and inside the linebacker. He does a nice job of just getting in between the coverage.
Fumble, and the Huskies jump on it. Coming in, the Huskies had 14 fumbles, lost only 7. And you see the Rutgers defense, though, coming in at plus 14, which is number one in the Big East, number two in the nation, as a matter of fact.
This is a team that stiffens up defensively the closer you get to that red zone by the 20-yard line. And George Johnson is a big part of pushing the pocket and really stopping teams from scoring.
Second 13 for Endress. Out of the shotgun. Twins to the top of your screen. Fires, has his man, Cunyu, inside the 20-yard line. So Brad Cunyu, the senior from Johnstown, Pennsylvania, grabs his 18th ball of the season.
Yeah, very dependable receiver on the outside. He's really come into his own in his senior year.
Inside Rentschler Field, the Big East Network Game of the Week, UConn against Rutgers, along with John Congemi, Quinn Kestnick. I'm Mike Gleason. And Quint mentioned it at the top of the show that the sun was trying to break through, and right now the skies are opening up, and it is a bright, sunshiny day here in Hartford. Endress, Kashif Moore, another grab. David Rowe, the sophomore from Cocoa, Florida, makes the stop.
Boy, that's a nice job by the Rutgers defense. All Mike Hicks, the right tackle for UConn, had to do was just get a little chip on David Rowe, and that may be to the house for 6 points. You can see Greg Schiano trying to talk to his team on the sidelines, but that was a great opportunity on third down for a big play.
36-yard kick. Taggart already one for one this afternoon, so the one didn't bother him the first time. This one from 36. And he pulled it left. So he's one for two. I mentioned he was 0 for 2 last week at West Virginia. He did make one, but a penalty flag negated that, brought it back, and he missed it the second time. Back in Hartford, UConn, Rutgers, with more after this.
What is it to lead? At PNC, it means building on a foundation of strength and stability. And now that National City is a part of PNC, it means that customers of both banks can look forward to greater possibilities than ever before. Together, we're even stronger. Together, we can do more. PNC, leading the way.
Looking for twice the thrill? At half the bill? Think Puerto Rico. Come to Puerto Rico and get 2 free nights when you stay 2 nights. Plus great discounts on sailing, snorkeling, hiking, sightseeing, and walking tours. You just can't afford to let this thrill pass you by. Book it today with your favorite travel partner. Puerto Rico, no passport required for U.S. citizens.
This thing rocks.
Lots of room back there in the back.
Hemi, top of the line.
Ram 1500, the most award-winning truck of 2009 and winner of Strategic Vision's Total Quality Award. Now very well-qualified lessees can lease a Ram 4x4 for just $459 a month.
Ever wonder what all these people are doing on their computers in a coffee shop? They're probably getting state minimum coverage from Safe Auto. Call 1-800-SAFE-AUTO or visit safeauto.com.
Kirstie Alley, why the fat actress is scrubbing toilets. Then new Haley Glassman with John Watching. Next ET.
Monday at 7 on WHAS 11.
The Halloween fire fiend from behind bars. Inside the mind of a madman. Next Inside Edition.
Monday at 7:30 on WHAS 11.
Welcome back to Hartford, Connecticut, a day where the Huskies return home to pay tribute to their fallen teammate, Jasper Howard. 2 weeks ago, lost his life in a senseless fatal stabbing, number six. All over the stadium here today. A week ago, the Huskies coming up short, 28-24. Today, trying to redeem themselves and win one for their fallen teammate, Jasper Howard. Right now, they trail in the ballgame 7-3 as the Wildcat now for the Scarlet Knights. And Mohamed Sanu, the true freshman, when he runs the Wildcat, you brought it up after that Pittsburgh game. It seems like Pittsburgh didn't have an answer for him.
And not many teams do. He gets running north and south. This is a big body at 6'2", 215, and he's such a threat on the outside when he catches the football. He gets in that direct snap and at the quarterback position in shotgun. He gets going downhill. He's tough to bring down.
Well, Sanu goes back a wide right top of your screen, and Tom Savage, the freshman quarterback, under center again. Savage right down the middle, going for the deep ball. He finds Timmy Brown. Number two, Timmy Brown, says this is a very, very important game for him because he and Jasper Howard were extremely close.
Yeah, very close. You know, guys that grew up together in the same neighborhood and played against each other. And, you know, just one of those things where he wants to come out and play for Jazz. And on that particular play, had it been a better thrown ball, he'd have went in for 6 points for Jazz.
Tim Brown has 62 tattooed on his right bicep. Stands for 62nd Street in Miami. They played at opposing high schools, he and Jasper Howard, but 1 mile apart. Savage, pump fake, fires, had his man open, overshot Sanu at about the 49-yard line. Coming over number 15, Jerome Jr., the redshirt freshman out of Baltimore.
You know, Mike, that win may be playing tricks on the young quarterback because the first series he came out and fired to his right side to Sanu and threw a very accurate ball. This time going to his left side, maybe where that wind had changed when Quint talked about the wind changing. Both those balls seemed to carry and both were overthrown.
Yeah, I would think the quarterback's just psychologically, every time you throw the ball, wondering if the wind is going to play havoc with the pass. Delegana now punting just shy of his 15. High spiral kick. And this is McLean at the 25. Reggie McLean dropped at the 30. A return to five. Gary Wilburn making a stop. 50-yard punt, 6-yard return. The Big East Network brings you more exciting college football action Saturday, November 7th. Coach Steve Craigthorpe and the Louisville Cardinals fly over to Mountaineer Field to take on West Virginia. And their elusive running back, Noel Devine. All the action getting underway Saturday, November 7th at noon only on the Big East Network. Noel Devine against these Huskies, 171 of his 178 yards in the second half. Boy, USF holding him to 42 last night in that victory over West Virginia. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by Overstock.com. Razzle dazzle, play action, Endress going up deep, and some miscommunication looking for the freshman again, Dwayne Gifton, out of Fort Lauderdale, St. Thomas Aquinas. They opened up last week's game with that flea flicker.
Yeah, they tried to go deep to him and the ball was overthrown. This time they try to go to the young Dwayne Gifton on the Connecticut sideline and really nothing there. So, and just threw it out of play, smart play, come back on second down and see if you can get something going.
Gifton, one of the big time recruits here for Randy Edsel. Endress trying to set up that screen pass, feeling some heavy pressure though, and it took a little bit too long to materialize as Blair Bynes, who had the big safety last year's game, comes up with the pressure. Randy Edsel, a pillar of strength. Boy, he has been monumental in the recovering process for this football team. A penalty flag was dropped.
I think Cody Endress as well, Mike, is down holding his left shoulder, and I think that's a major concern for Randy Edsel. We talked about the quarterback position yesterday, and it looked like he took a big shot on that screen play. Zach Frazier, who was the starter at the beginning of the year, is now 100% healthy and was clearly the number two quarterback coming into the game. And you got to hope Endress's left shoulder, it looks like he's been motioning towards that left shoulder, is going to be okay.
Endress, you could see as that play materialized or didn't materialize, for lack of a better term, he was waiting for the guys to get open, and finally he just had to dump it off because Bynes was coming, and he was coming hard.
Well, there's a lot of pressure on the pocket, and it was a slow developing screenplay. See if we can take a look. If he lands funny, he lands right on that left shoulder. There's two bodies right on him, and it looked like he just landed in an awkward fashion on that left shoulder.
See, his number is 4 for 9 at 40 yards. The last 3 weeks, 17 of 23, a buck 97 against Pittsburgh, 273 against Louisville 2 weeks ago, 378, a career high against West Virginia last week. And here's Zach Frazier now.
Yeah,
working
difficult,
out of the shotgun.
Difficult situation coming in. Really, you're not throwing any passes. May just try to get one outside.
Frazier fires. Should have been caught. First one, Ryan Griffin. And so Zach Frazier comes off the bench cold and should have had a completed ball.
Well, both of these UConn quarterbacks have been on the mark early when they've decided to throw the football to their tight end, Ryan Griffin. We've had two drops on the afternoon. This is a well-thrown ball, well-timed offensive play right on the numbers in between that zone coverage. You have to make that catch to move the chains in such a – it's going to be a tight contest this afternoon.
See, Desi Cullen, 43.6 average. That's number two in the Big East now. This one hits at about the 12-yard line and just stops. That's some pretty good punting there. It's dead at the 10-yard line, a 58-yard punt for the senior from Louisville, Kentucky. And now the Scarlet Knights will get the football back, but they are about 89 yards away as we take a look at Cody Endress, and they're looking at that shoulder. You know, Cody Endress finally got his shot last year against Cincinnati because Frazier was hurt. Frazier got his shot because Tyler Lorenzen got hurt.
Yeah, a lot of injuries at this quarterback position over the last couple of seasons have given opportunity to the guy in that backup role. And right now it looks like Zach Frazier is going to get that opportunity.
Savage keeps it on the ground. Martinick. He has nowhere to go. Jesse Joseph, another true freshman from Laval, Quebec, coming in to make the tackle.
We talked to defensive coordinator yesterday, Hank Hughes, about the two young guys. One was Trevardo Williams. The other guy was Jesse Joseph. Watch Jesse Joseph just come right across the big block of Anthony Davis and make a huge play. And sometimes, you know, I have to watch myself when I talk to these young guys because I can't believe what I'm saying to them, but I'm just trying to make them tougher, and that's one of the guys that are making plays on the outside.
Both of them true freshmen. They will be tougher as their years progress. Out of the shotgun and the Wildcat again. It's Sanu trying to weave his way through traffic. Gets just past the line of scrimmage. Not much there, and we go back downstairs with Quint.
Cody Endress was taken to the locker room after a left shoulder evaluation. Trainer Bob Howard told me he's taken inside. They're going to take a closer look, take off the shoulder pads, and actually take an x-ray. So it looks like Zach Frazier is the guy.
All right, thanks a lot, Quint. Frazier, of course, also out of Pennsylvania, went to Notre Dame and transferred back to UConn. 0 for 2 on third down now. Rutgers on the day. This one third and 10. Savage will work from the shotgun.
And this will be big, Mike, for field position for UConn if they can get a stop.
Plenty of time for Savage. Swings it out, and it's complete. This one goes to Cordell Young, who at one time they thought he'd be the next because of that sore knee. He's become a third down back.
He really has. He's been one of those guys coming in and trying to catch passes out of the backfield, and Joe Martinick's gotten the majority of the carries along with Brooks. But Cordell Young, a junior out of New Jersey, he's been productive in his career, but just not this year. Hasn't had as many touches as he normally does.
Well, John, Teddy Delagana now is back near his goal line, so you can see field position slowly favoring the Huskies. Now McLean and Nick Williams, the freshman, standing at their own 40. Another high spiral kick. And again, it's McLean at the 30, and he dropped the football, hit his pad, and he caught it. Wow, he can breathe a deep sigh of relief.
And not many times will that ball hit you in the helmet, bounce straight up with two gunners coming down at you. They both miss you, and that ball comes right back in your arms. You can see McLean trying to get a bead on it, hit him right in the face mask, and then just missed by one of the gunners coming down. It looked like it was McCourty, and then bounced right back into Robert McLean's hands. So Randy Edsel trying to talk to him. Hey, catch the ball clean out there. Give us some field position. That was a good punt there by the special teams.
Yeah, 54-yard punt by Teddy Delagana. So Zach Frazier under center now. The I formation, and Todman docks the I. Penalty flag will stop this one before it gets rolling.
All-star, 78 offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That goes against the right guard, Zach Hurd. Now, keep in mind the Huskies, though, the least penalized team in the Big East. They came in with 29, about four a game, or 29 yards a game.
Yeah, that's one of the things you don't see much out of the UConn Huskies on both sides of the football. They're very disciplined up front on the line of scrimmage for Randy Edsall, and it's one of the advantages they come in to the game with.
Huskies stay in the eye. Todman dots it once again. He gets the call, and he is going down. Very quickly, number 17, and Adamos Almunoz, the senior out of Miami, making the stop.
Munoz read that all the way, and you can hear the hits from up here. Big hit on Jordan Todman. No running room in the middle. Big number 17 is going to fill that gap, and there's no running room. Good pressure from the inside as well by the defensive front for Rutgers, but a difficult second and long now set up by Munoz.
Frazier over the middle. This one's picked off. Number 17, and Munoz makes the tackle. Now he gets the pick. Damaso.
We talked about the timing in the pass offense. Anytime that you're late over the middle, sometimes bad things happen. And he was trying to get that second window in between the linebackers, but just a terrific read by Munoz. He came up with the big play on the running play, and then you can see just a little bit late on the throw, he had to let Munoz just slide by, but nice hand shown by the big linebacker out of Miami, Florida, and that's the fifth interception by Zach Frazier on this season.
And look at plus 14 coming into the ball game. They get another one right there. Now Savage with great field position just outside the red zone, working from the shotgun, feels the pressure, avoids it, but he's going down. Jesse Joseph, the first to get his hands on him. Again, the true freshman playing a very good ball game early on, along with Kendall Reyes, the redshirt sophomore. Very young defensive front up there.
Very young defensively, especially on the edge. And we talked to head coach Randy Edsall about some of the young guys. And Jesse Joseph was right up there along with Williams on the edge. But a good job on defensive line. They have great size on both sides of the offense and defensive lines. And there's a little bit of advantage, it seems like, on that offensive side.
Second and 13. They're back in the Wildcat. That's Sanu. Hesitates. Takes off. Not too much running room. Sniffed out nicely by the Huskies. And Sanu, as we mentioned in that Pittsburgh game, he had 29 yards rushing on just four carries. Didn't seem like the Panthers had the answer, but right now the Huskies not giving him much running room.
Yeah, I think the Rutgers Scarlet Knights were their own worst enemies on that Wildcat formation on second down. The timing of it was off, and all UConn had to do was stay at home.
Third and 12.
Nice situation to go to Tim Brown. We haven't seen him yet. He's in the slot at the top.
Savage just gets rid of the football, and again, pressure, and again, it's a true freshman, Trevardo Williams. Number 48, 6'1", 221. Not the biggest defensive end, at least yet, but three times in high school he finished in the top five of the 100 meters.
Well, great job coming on a little game. He started at that left defensive end to the short side of the field. He came right up the middle untouched and really put a good shot on Tom Savage. He really had nowhere to go with the football, and that'll bring on San Santee for this field goal opportunity.
41-yard attempt. His long this year is 41. And this one sails wide right. So San Santee came in 11 of 16. Make that 11 of 17 now here in 2009. Never too early to start talking UConn basketball. Don't miss the chance to see Coach Calhoun's Huskies battle John Calipari's Kentucky Wildcats. That's coming up in the third annual SEC Big East Invitational held in Madison Square Garden on December 9th. For tickets and travel, visit secbigeastinvitational.com.
Mike, it's always a difficult situation when you're the backup quarterback. You get into the game early, and you don't have success early where you throw an interception. You have a ball dropped, and now you come back in, and you try to get the running game going.
Here's the running game with Andre Dixon. He follows that sweep to the right side, gets over the 25-yard line, picks up a couple. Antonio Lowry, number 50, making the initial contact. Lowry, along with Tim Brown, Lowry said that he and Tim Brown hung out with Jasper Howard at the beach a week before all the guys reported to their respective camps.
We talked about it earlier, you know, a number of players on both sides from the state of Florida, so they had a relationship with Jazz.
Fifth possession for UConn this quarter. We still have 62 seconds to go in the quarter. Out of the eye formation, Frazier fires. Far side, Kunyu with his second catch of the afternoon, up near, close to the first down. Should be a little bit shy. David Rowe making the stop defensively.
Nice decision by the junior quarterback, Zach Frazier. Everybody dropping off in coverage, and he had Brad Kunyu out to the wide side of the field. He made a nice accurate throw, now puts his team in a good third and one situation where they can do a number of things here on third and short.
And they're 1-for-4 on third down here this afternoon. On the year, very, very productive, 41% on third down. Out of the eye, Anthony Sherman, the lead back at fullback. Frazier wants to throw it. He finds his man. This time, Ryan Griffin has it, and he's wrestled down at about the 40-yard line. Little Bart star Max McGee there, big third down play. Huh?
Nice job. I mentioned you can do a number of things on third and one where Rutgers really trying to crowd the line of scrimmage, and you're going to see the tight end Griffith just go on a little corner route after the play action, and it's a nice job of Zach Frazier showing the football there, and then he's wide open. The corner and comes up on the flat route. The safety cannot get off the hash, and this time Ryan Griffith makes the catch. He had dropped two earlier in this football game, but on third and short comes up with a big play for the Huskies.
And the final play of the first quarter, as a matter of fact, goes 28 yards. And right now, the Huskies paying tribute to their fallen teammate, Jasper Howard, trailing in the ballgame now. 7-3. Randy Edsel trying to rally the troops. Huskies back home for the first time since the tragic death of their teammate known as Jazz.
My school couldn't afford to buy a piano, so my mom decided to give them ours. It's the piano her dad gave her when she was a little girl. She loved it so much. I don't know why she was so happy to give it away.
This is the information retailers don't want you to know, especially now. They don't want you to learn just how much money you've been giving away to retail markups on items you purchase for your home, all because you don't know how to buy like the insiders do at Direct Buy Club, the home improvement and furnishings club with direct insider prices.
The best thing about Direct Buy is you're getting the best price that you can, and it's very easy to go shopping at Direct Buy.
I've purchased coffee pot, toaster, blender, food processor, all of those things. The savings is significant. It truly is.
And now, for the first time ever, Direct Buy is offering you a certificate for a free 30-day membership. Members buy top-quality name-brand merchandise from hundreds and hundreds of trusted manufacturers. So call the number on your screen now, and we'll rush you your free visitor's pass to your local Direct Buy club and your certificate for a free 30-day membership. This is a limited offer, so call now. No dealers, please.
My friend thinks she's a beauty. My dad thinks she's a cutie. She even caught the eye of my mom. I found her online at buyayousedride.com.
Buy a used ride that makes everyone jealous. Buyayousedride.com wants to get you approved and on the road today. Get behind the wheel with a job and a down payment. It's the credit you deserve. Apply online today.
Buyayousedride.com.
What does having the highest customer loyalty of any brand mean? It means great cars being built by great people. And we're proud to say our East Liberty, Ohio factory ranked highest for initial quality among all the auto plants in America.
What the crusade means to me is major. Saved his life. It's totally a miracle.
100% of your donations to the WHAS Crusade for Children help children with special needs. Through the Crusade, you've changed the lives of 3 million children in Kentucky and Indiana since 1954. Right now, you're funding 1 in 3 children who needs the Crusade.
Help us do more.
Change a child's life. Support the WHAS Crusade for Children.
WHAS 11 News, 11 at 11, tonight.
We've played 15 minutes of football, and John Kanjemi, it didn't take Rutgers long to come up with a key play.
No, the opening kickoff goes 98 yards. Devin McCourty just taking it, follow his good blocking, and it makes the kicker miss. Des Cullen right about the 30-yard line, and his speed gets him in the end zone and started the scoring off at 7-0. And UConn answered with a field goal. Randy Etzel had great field position on his opening kickoff. They answer with a field goal. Now the UConn Huskies driving again with the ball at the 39-yard line.
Zach Frazier at the controls. Cody Endress went out with a shoulder injury, and Andre Dixon gets the call. He puts his head down and gets stopped just shy of the 35-yard line. Dixon coming in with a 100-yard game against Ohio, 149 against Baylor, and 153 against Louisville. But he flirted with 100 two other times, 98 against Rhode Island, 95 against Pittsburgh. So he almost has 5 100-yard games already this year.
Yeah, Dixon's a great runner in between the tackles.
Todman now goes outside the tackles, and he's pushed out of bounds. Coming up to make the initial contact is number 45, Alex Silvestro, the defensive end, the junior out of Gibbstown, New Jersey.
Mike, I think both of these running backs complement each other, because Andre Dixon, he's the workhorse. He's in between the tackles, getting those tough yards. And Jordan Todman last week against West Virginia, he was the guy, 94 yards on 20 touches, you know, a little bit faster paced game. And head coach Randy Edsel thought he could get in and out of those holes much quicker. Now a big third down for UConn with their backup quarterback, Zach Frazier.
Frazier out of the gun. Fires. Kanyu. A lot of zip on the ball, maybe a little bit high, but I'm always torn. I mean, they say if a receiver can touch the football, but that one looked just a little bit too high.
A little bit too high, but I'm never torn. If it touches the receiver's hands, you better catch it. I'm a one-way street when it comes to that. I'm selfish.
Spoken like a quarterback. John Kanjemi throwing for over 4,600 yards during his days at Pittsburgh, or 6,500, 46 touchdowns, I should say. Well, Zach Frazier didn't know that one was coming, and this one's picked off. Penalty flag dropped, and that was Joe LaFege coming up with the interception. And to talk about a strange series of events.
Motion on the offense. Penalty's a crime. First down.
Well, sometimes coaches always tell you don't make a bad play worse, and Zach Frazier was not ready for this shotgun snap. It was snapped early by Mo Petras, and he wasn't ready. He was lucky that he caught the football, but the worst thing you can do is maybe force a play that doesn't have any rhythm. You can see the ball's going to be snapped, and no one really has an idea. Half the team knows it's snapped. Half the team lets up. The linemen stop blocking, but Zach Frazier retreats and throws the football late over the middle carelessly. Right to Joe LaFege, and ends up with the interception.
Joe Martinick in the backfield now. That's Mohamed Sanu in motion. And the handoff to Martinick, and he has nowhere to go. Kendall Reyes comes over from the left side to drag him down. Cody Endress, the starting quarterback for UConn, 65%. He's on the sidelines now with the on the left there, wearing the number 6 jersey, out with the sling on that left shoulder. That doesn't look good.
No, it doesn't, and it really doesn't bode well for UConn's offense. And this is how he gets hurt. You can watch his left shoulder just gets pinned down on the ground, and doesn't look good for him returning in this football game.
Savage. Nice job of avoiding the rush. Here comes the heat by big number 99 again. Kendall Reyes really putting on the heat on the far sideline, and the ball falls incomplete.
It's nice anticipation by a young quarterback, and Greg Schiano told us, you know, he's slowly starting to recognize things, and that time he felt the pressure of the pocket, and that comes with experience. He felt that he was getting a little blur of blue from his left side, and Greg Schiano likes what he sees, the maturity level in a young quarterback, and he really got out of trouble, threw the football away, and they come back on third down.
Savage, 3 for 8 for 25 yards here in the second quarter. Savage over the middle. This one's complete. And it's Tim Brown pulling in his 32nd reception. A penalty flag dropped at about the 33-yard line. And it's going to be against the Scarlet Knights. Looks like a motion penalty, John.
Boy, and that's a big play that's going to be brought back. A nice job of timing by Savage.
75 offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Good timing on the play by Savage to Brown. They get motion, and that, you know, that upsets head coach Greg Schiano. Really didn't see it on the interior line. I'm not sure if one of the wideouts moved a little bit early, but you can see him thread the needle. Just a perfect ball, great timing. Brown's that big play guy. He's averaging over 20 yards per catch. He'll need to come up with another one now on 3rd and 13.
Savage, the true freshman quarterback, out of the shotgun. Pump fake, right, comes back left, Sanu. Good open field tackle by number 42. That's Robert McLean, the senior from Lusby, Maryland.
Boy, Mike, you couldn't have called it any better. He was the only guy out there on the short side of the field. Robert McLean takes down big Mohamed Sanu. Sanu goes 6'2", 215, and McLean only at 5'9", but did an excellent job of tackling in space. You have to be good at the cornerbacks, and that's what Randy Etzel preaches. You have to tackle, get helmets around the football. That time, McLean tackling in space.
Teddy Delegana with a 58 and a 54-yard punt so far here this afternoon. Robert McLean, Nick Williams, both at about the 23-yard line. There's the whistle and the penalty flag before the kick. And we've got some movement there,
a false start. 17 offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
So Munoz, the linebacker, a little bit over-eager.
Well, after that interception, over the middle, Rutgers moving backwards, and it's been their own fault in procedure penalties. So going backwards are the Scarlet Knights and UConn trying to get better field position.
See, on the season, 51 yards a game. Much more penalized team than the UConn Huskies, already with 25. Delegana. This one's not quite as far. It's going to hit at about the 32, and it takes a Rutgers bounce inside the 20. And it'll be down at the 18-yard line, and that's where the Huskies will start after another 50-yard punt. So he's at a 58, a 54, and a 50-yard punt here this afternoon. When we come back, Zach Frazier trying to get something going, filling in for Cody Endress at quarterback for the UConn Huskies.
What is it to lead? At PNC, it means building on a foundation of strength and stability. And now that National City is a part of PNC, it means that customers of both banks can look forward to greater possibilities than ever before. Together, we're even stronger. Together, we can do more. PNC, leading the way.
There's so much craziness.
Visit Overstock.com and find everything that you want, with name brand products at up to 70% off every day.
When all my faith has gone, you bring it back to me. You make it real for me.
Your entire order ships for just $2.95. Overstock.com, at home with the O.
It's an SEC Big East Invitational doubleheader live from Madison Square Garden on December 9th. Don't miss your opportunity to sit front and center as the Georgia Bulldogs face St. John's. Then John Calipari's Wildcats face the UConn Huskies with one of the most feared guard tandems in the country. Now's the time to get your tickets. Call 212-307-7171 or go to www.secbigeastinvitational.com.
Can lease a Journey SXT for just $319 a month.
What you want?
You want to
to save big on your cell phone and internet service? Get Cricket. Right now, when you bundle Cricket's unlimited mobile broadband with an unlimited talk plan, it's just a flat rate of $65 total. Just call 1-800-395-9468 or click mycricket.com. $65 a month total for unlimited broadband and talk. Act now for this free USB modem and get a free month of service. Unlimited internet for your desktop or laptop on America's most affordable 3G network. With no contracts to sign and no overages, call Click or come in today. Get respect for your wallet. Cricket.
Welcome back to the Big East Network Game of the Week, presented by PNC. 7-3 Rutgers on top of UConn. We go downstairs with Quinn.
Mike, instability at the quarterback position has really been a storyline in the Big East this year. Today for UConn, Cody Endress is done with a left shoulder injury. Enter Zach Frazier. Now, Frazier's a kid who's gotten playing time in the past. He's always caught the injury bug. Two concussions back in 08, including one against Rutgers. He actually wears a special padded helmet. He's also had knee surgery. Keep in mind, he did come into fall camp this year as the number one quarterback on the depth chart.
All right, thanks a lot, Quince. And Andre Dixon gets the call, gets out to the outside. And a good open field tackle that time by number 26. That's Joe LaFesh. You know, Joe Moorhead telling us yesterday, though, that they've worked so hard with Cody Endress about making sure the ball goes to the open guy, goes to the right guy, and now he goes down with the injury.
Yeah, it's one of those things that, you know, he was saying how Cody was developing and getting more mature and getting more confidence in each week. And you could see it last week at West Virginia when he had career high completions and yardage, and now the backup quarterback, Zach Frazier, needing to get fire.
Todman this time goes right, and he cuts it back up inside over the 25-yard line. Antonio Lowry making the stop for Rutgers. Zach Frazier, of course, the quarterback, he was all-everything in Pennsylvania coming out. Went to Notre Dame, and I mean, anytime you're recruited to Notre Dame, you're recruited to Notre Dame.
Yeah, right? And this is one of the best remedies to really get a quarterback that's rushed into the game that really hasn't started the way he wanted to, that running game. And this UConn running game, it all starts with that offensive line. So if, as they go, he'll get better in this football game.
Huskies, 2 of 6 on third down. Oh! And there is some contact down there on third down that time as Andre Dixon got the call. There's Antonio Lowry, a junior out of Miami.
Yeah, that was a collision. You can see it right here. Lowry comes right in, slips the block of Anthony Davis, the fullback, and lets the running game of Connecticut have it in the backfield. There was no running room in the middle, and that was all due to Lowry shooting that gap from that linebacker spot.
So Desi Cullen on for the punt now. He'll be punting it at about the 15, just over the 15-yard line. Mohamed Sanu is going to let this one go as he waves it off. And this time it gets a little Husky bounce inside the 20. And so Rutgers started their last drive at the 18, and now the Huskies will start at the 18 after a 54-yard punt. So both punters having a very, very good afternoon. Score 7-3, Rutgers on top.
The Ohio State University.
The University of Texas.
Southern University.
California, Berkeley.
Old Dominion University.
Harvard University.
The University of Virginia.
Here, Texas A&M.
Norfolk State University.
Georgia University.
Arizona State.
Pennsylvania State University.
The few, the proud, the Marines.
Appetizers, gentlemen.
I'll start with the steak tartare.
And you, sir?
I'll have the same. But hold the tartar sauce.
The tartar sauce? Really?
I don't like it.
The more you save on insurance, the more you'll have for football. Drivers who switch their home and auto to Allstate saved an average of $503 a year. Are you in good hands?
Ooh, creamy brulee.
Injured? Turn to someone you can trust.
A car crash can cause serious injury to you, destroying your car and possibly your life. Don't go down the wrong road by dealing with the insurance company.
Call the Becker Law Office at 1-800-755-3000.
Papa John wants everyone to know why our pizza's better, so he's bringing it right to them.
Papa's in the house!
Papa's in the house.
Firefighters by nature are carnivores.
Introducing Papa John's new Six Meats Pizza, loaded with six delicious meats. For a limited time, get a large Six Meats Pizza or a large Six Cheese Pizza. Your choice, just $10.99. Plus, add a large one-topping pizza for just $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's!
Papa's in the fire!
Hurt in a car wreck? Call the Becker Law Office for zero stress, zero worry, zero wait, and zero fees unless we recover money for you. We have helped over 30,000 injured people, and we'd like to help you.
Pick up the phone and call the Becker Law Office.
1 year ago, Rutgers prevailed thanks to a safety 12-10 that opened the door to close the season on a seven-game winning streak. And right now, looking for that first Big East victory, they're up 7-3 in the second. Not a lot of offense in this football game.
No, not a lot of offense by Rutgers other than that opening 98-yard kick return by McCourty. Really no offense to show for, and that's the points that Rutgers has. So I'm looking for them to maybe come out and get a big play from Mohamed Sanu or Tim Brown on the outside, try to make up for some lost time here in this first half.
Well, Greg Schiano is looking for a spark from another true freshman out of Woodbridge, Virginia, DeAntoine Williams, in the backfield now. Savage gives it to the young freshman. We saw him play against Howard, and he's got some wheels. I think he had like 12 carries for 89 yards in that game.
He really does, Mikey. And he's very elusive, very quick running. He gets to that hole with authority. Not a big back, but a very elusive back. You can see his size, 5'8", 195. Very strong, Woodbridge, Virginia. And you see his high school career, 83 touchdowns. So he knows how to get in the end zone.
There's a few memories there, huh? 83
Absolutely.
Touchdowns. Had 132 yards and a touchdown against Texas Southern. And then he didn't play much, and people were wondering why Greg Schiano burned the red shirt. He said, well, he's a good player, but he's a freshman. He makes mistakes, and the best guy plays, and that's been Joe Martinick mostly.
And most of the time, it's probably in pass protection, and Greg Schiano wants to protect his young quarterback because he also is a freshman, so you want to have somebody in there with more experience in picking up those schemes and protecting your franchise 6'5 quarterback in Tom Savage.
0 for 5 on third down. Another big third down situation for the Scarlet Knights. Tom Savage making his first Big East road start. Goes up over the middle looking for Timmy Brown's. Got it! Just shy of the 50-yard line. A diving stab. Tim Brown, the 5'8", 165-pound senior. They're going to wave it off. Looked like he had the football.
It looked like a terrific catch, and now it looks like they're waving it off. I know Tim Brown thinks he had the football. That was a terrific pass by Tom Savage. He threw this football well before Brown's going to break. You can see Brown the top of your screen. That ball's in the air well before he comes out of that break and just looked like a terrific throw and catch.
Wow.
It looked like he had the football on first take, Mike, but that's just an awesome job by Tom Savage anticipating where Brown was going to break out on that corner route. That looked like a clean catch to me.
He's got his arm under it.
Absolutely looked like a clean catch.
Rutgers, their first timeout.
And I think Greg Schiano is going to take timeout so they can maybe take another look at this.
30-second timeout.
That's the first of three timeouts for Rutgers. UConn yet to use one up. Tom Tomczyk, our referee today, and Noel Turner is the replay official up in the booth.
I don't really see that ball from that look making a move when Brown hit the ground. It looked like he had control of the football, and the officials obviously saw something different on the near side to make that an incompletion. But it definitely looked like a catch to me at first glance, and then taking another look at it, looked like Brown had possession of that football.
Well, you were definitely right when you said Tim Brown was a little bit shocked and confused because he thought he had it. Looked like he had that arm under it. But regardless of what we say, it's
fourth down.
Fourth down.
Yeah.
And Teddy Delagana coming back on the field for the Scarlet Knights.
Ruling on the play is under further review.
It's going back upstairs to Noel Turner now. I'm glad they did this. I think Mr. Turner, who's done a great job this year, will make the right call.
They have to have clear evidence that that ball is moving to overturn this call, because it was a terrific catch. It looked like a terrific catch by Brown, and great anticipation by Savage. You can see the ball there cradled into his stomach, and from that angle you really can't see if the ball moved. From this angle, it doesn't look like the ball moves at all. Maybe it touches the ground there, and the side judge that was on the UConn sideline right here makes the call. So he's the official that makes the call on the sideline. If Brown had possession of this football, we're going to take another look as we slow it down.
I don't know.
It sure looked like he caught the football, but there was really no hesitation by that official when he came in to say no catch.
Looking for indisputable video evidence to overrule. Tom Tomczyk awaits the call, as does Greg Schiano and Randy Edsel. I know what Tim Brown will tell you.
I caught the football.
Absolutely.
After further review, the ruling on the field is a completed catch. The receiver got his hands under the ball, caught the ball. It'll be Rutgers' ball on the Rutgers 48-yard line. First down.
And that's good coaching by Greg Schiano. He called the timeout. He bought himself some time. They were able to do that and get the call reversed, and that's the first down in over 20 minutes for the Scarlet Knights. So a terrific job by Tom Savage anticipating where Tim Brown was going to come out of that break and throw a strike.
Today's first and 10 line is brought to you by Overstock.com. Their first play from scrimmage was a first down, and that's over 13 minutes, or 13:32, I should say, of the first quarter, as DeAntoine Williams gets the call. Tries to hit the right side. Not too much running room there for the 5'8", 195-pounder.
There hasn't been a lot of running room on either side. You know, Rutgers trying to establish the run as Connecticut, but a nice job by Lawrence Wilson, who I had a chance to speak with yesterday, and we're going to see on Kenjemi's corner coming up at halftime. Bama, as they call him, doing a nice job coming up and filling the hole up front.
That's Cordell Young now, the redshirt junior, in the backfield with Savage, who works out of the gun. Plenty of time this time, and Tim Brown pulls in another one. He pays the price, but it's a completed ball. There's your number 8, Lawrence Wilson, the number 1 tackler in the Big East Conference.
Nice job by Tom Savage hanging in that pocket. You're going to see the game on the inside coming around, and Witten almost gets there, but a good job of holding his own in the pocket. But the big hit by Bama, doing a nice job, the junior out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama, Lawrence Wilson, making a play on the edge.
Third and 5 at the 47. Savage steps up in the pocket to find his man, Sanu. And that's a first down for Rutgers. But that offensive line now doing a nice job giving Savage plenty of time.
Yeah, there was a nice pocket, and Tom Savage was able to come back and give himself enough time to let Sanu, the freshman, come from his left side on that little dig route, that in route. You're going to see the wall of protection here. A good job of stepping up into the pocket and throwing a strike to his freshman wide receiver.
So now Savage working with a first and 10 from the 37-yard line. Again, right up the middle, Brown. Touchdown, Rutgers. Tim Brown out of Miami. His fourth touchdown catch this year. This one goes for 37.
Just a terrific job by Savage in this Rutgers offense, who waited a long time for their second first down. Well, they come in succession. They do a good job here of protecting the pocket again and giving enough time for Tim Brown. He really set up a double move. He goes to the outside and then waited for the football on the inside. Bleedy Ray Wilson on the outside looking for Tim Brown. Couldn't find him because he was at the post waiting around the 5-yard line for that touchdown strike.
Long faces here in Rentschler Field. On a day they're honoring their number 6, Jasper Howard. San T back on the field. Tim Brown, that's his 15th career touchdown. San T gets another PAT, and Greg Schiano now finally finding some offense right after we put that graphic up. Says, hey, let's get this offense rolling. And Tom Savage using that right arm this time.
Yeah, nice job by Tom Savage. Great protection. Had time for that double move. Tim Brown waiting at the goal line for a touchdown strike.
What is it to lead? At PNC, it means building on a foundation of strength and stability. And now that National City is a part of PNC, it means that customers of both banks can look forward to greater possibilities than ever before. Together, we're even stronger. Together, we can do more. PNC, leading the way. It's time.
From the number one maker of ATVs and side-by-sides comes the 70-horsepower Sportsman 850 XP. The new Ranger 800 XP with 15% more power. And the all-new workhorse, the midsize Ranger 400. Polaris, hardest working, smoothest riding.
Katie, hey, give me that. Someday I'll do something about that. I'm Justin Katie.
I learned early on it's wise to avoid a middleman.
It'll cost ya.
At Safe Auto, you save on state minimum coverage because we cut out the middleman.
Safe Auto, this is Kate. May I help you?
Katie? You gotta have coverage. You wanna save money. Call 1-800-SAFE-AUTO or visit safeauto.com and do both.
Safe Auto.
What you want?
To save big on your cell phone and internet service? Get Cricket. Right now, when you bundle Cricket's unlimited mobile broadband with an unlimited talk plan, it's just a flat rate of $65 total. Just call 1-800-395-9468 or click mycricket.com. $65 a month total for unlimited broadband and talk. Act now for this free USB modem and get a free month of service. Unlimited internet for your desktop or laptop on America's most affordable 3G network. With no contracts to sign and no overages, call, click, or come in today. Get respect for your wallet. Cricket.
Today's Big East Network game is brought to you by the third annual SEC Big East Invitational, December 9th and 10th in both New York and Tampa. And by Allstate. You're in good hands. Back in Hartford, last drive, Tim Brown was in good hands with the young freshman quarterback, Savage, who completed every pass on that drive.
Yeah, 4 for 4 for 69 yards on the drive, and just a nice job of getting some rhythm back in the Rutgers offense. They've gone a long time without a first down. Well, they got a couple first downs on the drive, and then the big play, Savage to Brown for 6 points.
Well, they say success breeds confidence, and Tom Savage said in the Pittsburgh game, even though they lost the game, he really felt comfortable after the game that because Pittsburgh obviously is a legit big-time football program. Elegana. Fry at the goal line. Fry. 40. Fry. 50. Robbie Fry just shy. No! He got it! What a great effort by Robbie Fry! Devin McCourty, who returned the opening kickoff 98 yards, had the last shot at him, and I thought he had him.
100 yards, Robbie Fry with the answer. Just a great job to get this crowd back into it. But just an awesome block around the 50-yard line that really sprung Fry into the end zone. And you can see that UConn sideline getting excited about it.
Robbie Fry came in averaging 25.4, number 3 in the Big East behind Cameron Sadler of Pittsburgh and Marty Gilliard of Cincinnati. Averaging 75 yards per kickoff return this afternoon.
And it was Jordan Todman, the running back.
It's under further review.
It was Jordan Todman that gets the block that springs Robbie Fry. Now the officials are going to see if he was in the end zone or not, if that knee touched before the goal line. But what an effort by Fry.
A week ago at West Virginia, Fry returned a kick.
Let's see if we can see it, Mike. It looks like that ball just gets over. Ooh. I think that's a touchdown. Oh. There's no doubt about it. That knee never touched.
Well, the decision lies in the hands of Noel Turner now, the replay official up in the booth. He will make the call. Indisputable video evidence. That's what they're looking for to overturn it.
That's a great effort. I don't think that left knee ever touched the ground. That looked like 6 points.
It was close, but all he has to do is just touch that white line or cross it. Yeah, you're right, John. Robbie Fry, 100 yards. UConn's last kick return for a touchdown. It was Tyvon Branch back in 2007. He had 97 yards against the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers.
Boy, and you have to credit the effort on that special teams, the big block by Jordan Todman.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
I'll tell you this, John. Noel Turner's 2 for 2 up in the booth today.
Yeah, and they were both pretty clear cut. I thought the catch by Brown for Rutgers was a clean catch, and Robbie Fry getting congratulations and hugs on the sidelines with his 100-yard kickoff return for a touchdown.
Third 100-yard return in UConn history. David Taggart now on the field looking for the PAT. 14-9, 5:52 to go before halftime. Taggart. And the whistle blew before the kick, penalty flag down. Taggart 25 of 25 this year.
Offside, 94 defense. Half the distance to the goal, re-kick.
Scott Ballone, the redshirt freshman from New York.
Correction, the penalty's declined.
Randy Edsel says, no, we won't take it. Let's just kick it, get the points, and let's make this a 14-10 ball game.
Well, for not a lot of action in that first quarter other than the opening kickoff, they've really answered with some fireworks as of late.
And Taggart right down the middle that time, so he's 26 of 26 this year, and the Huskies have their first touchdown. It's 14-10. Another look, John.
Yeah, Robbie Fry does an excellent job of getting the initial wall. You're going to see that wall of blockers right there. They seal everybody off. And then Jordan Todman, he's hustling down. He gets the block on the kicker. And then all Fry has to do is outrun McCourty to the corner of the end zone. A stiff arm at the 10-yard line really gets him into the end zone right there. Just a nice job of keeping some separation inside the 5-yard line and reaching that football over. And just great speed shown by Robbie Fry there and determination inside the 5-yard line. He would not be denied.
Yeah, Devin McCourty had the angle. Looked like he had a little more speed, but I thought maybe he misjudged Robbie Fry's speed as well. Great effort by number 44, Robbie Fry, redshirt sophomore. Two kickoff returns, over 90-plus. Now Greg Schiano talking to his defensive end, George Johnson. And Rutgers will have the football now with a 5:52 to go before halftime. Well, if you watched last week's UConn game with West Virginia, it was like a boxing match. There were punches and counter punches. And the same is going on here, but just in different style. Not quite as much offense as a week.
No, not as much, but defense is really playing well, and it's a battle along that line of scrimmage.
Joe Lefebvre, 2 yards deep. And Lefebvre, he's up over the 30, 35-yard line. And he's finally dropped down by number 7 coming over. That's Mike Lang, a backup wide receiver after the return of 36 yards.
So Joe Lefebvre gets the Rutgers Scarlet Knights and Tom Savage, their quarterback, in excellent field position. You can see big number 75, Anthony Davis, ready to go get himself. We were talking about him at one of the impact players maybe running on that left side. But he's had his hands full with that UConn defensive front today.
So after the 100-yard kickoff return, the UConn offense stays on the sideline, and Rutgers, Tom Savage, goes to work. And the handoff is the first carry this afternoon. Jordan Brooks gets the call. Robert McClain wrestles him down. Brooks, the redshirt sophomore from Germantown, Maryland, comes in averaging just about 5 yards a carry. Talk about this running game for Rutgers, too. I mean, Brooks, the game we did against Howard, he had 124 and 3 touchdowns. And now Bartnick with 3 100-yard games, and they go pretty deep.
They really do. They have 3 running backs that they've used today and all bring a different skill set for Greg Schiano and what he wants to do offensively.
Savage on second down. He's going down. 21st sack this year for the Huskies. Scott Lutris. That had to feel good. Lutris, the leader on that defense. He's been sitting out so many games with that stinger.
Yeah, he's been injured most of this season, but Scott Lutris, he got the clearance to come back and practice on Tuesday. You can see him at the top of the screen. He's just going to run right around the blocking and does an excellent job of just using his speed. It's going to be a quick pass, but Tom Savage never sees him. Didn't account for the linebacker getting on the outside and runs right by a would-be blocker for the sack.
Third and 13. Cordell Young in motion to the top of your screen. Savage over the middle. Complete to Tim Brown once again over the 45-yard line, and it'll be a first down.
There's going to be a late flag, it looked like, on Trevardo Williams tripping one of the offensive linemen really late after the play. Should be a personal foul.
Dead ball. Personal foul. 48 each defense. Unnecessary roughness. 15-yard penalty. First down.
It's just a bad play by a true freshman, Williams. Looked like a couple of the Rutgers Scarlet Knight offensive linemen running down the field to get into the play. And it was a blatant trip. He grabbed his leg, and you can see Randy Etzel upset on the play, but a good job of showing some courage by Tim Brown. He only goes 5'8", 165. You can see the big hookup right in that zone. Again, great anticipation and driving the football by Tom Savage.
Razzle-dazzle this time. And Tim Brown trying to sweep the right side. You know, John, we're talking about Tim Brown and the fact he was close with Jasper Howard. He said he's got that 62 on his bicep, tattooed. Significant for 62nd Avenue, went right down their neighborhood. They played high school ball, one at Northwestern, one at Edison, a mile apart. He said he wears number 2 and Jasper wore number 6. So that's 62 again. Very, very close friends.
Yeah, guys that spent a lot of time together in the offseason, in the summertime, and a lot of relationships with Jazz.
Brooks gets the call. Well, it was like the parting of the Red Sea that time. The right side of that offensive line. Barbieri, Haslam opening up the hole for Brooks. We're inside Rensselaer Field as Robert McLean goes down. Big East Network Game of the Week. Rutgers and UConn, along with John Congemi, the former Pitt quarterback. Quinn Kesnick down on the sidelines. I'm Mike Gleason. Great to have you with us. Randy Etzel. Well, what a job he did over the last 2 weeks. And Etzel says the game against West Virginia, it was so close, it was a heartbreaker, but he takes no solace in coming close in 3 losses. When you think about this team, they're 4-3, John, and they lost on a safety to North Carolina. Pittsburgh beat them as time expired on a field goal. And then Noel Devine tears their heart out with that 56-yard run last week.
Yeah, 9 points. So, you know, when you have plays like the one that just happened by a young defensive end in Trevardo Williams that gives another 15 yards and aids a drive. You can see Randy Etzel was upset with the officials and making the call so far back behind the line of scrimmage. But we're going to take a look at some of those losses, Mike, that you talked about. You know, you get the safety, you get the holding call in the end zone for 2 points against North Carolina, and that really in a tight ball game. So you get the safety, they lose by 2 points. And then as time expires against the Panthers, they rally. Big play there, but they get a field goal at the end of that football game. You can see not a lot of time on the clock. Actually, no time on the clock. And they get the victory. And then last week, with 2:18 remaining, Noel Devine goes 56 yards. Looked like may have been able to be pushed out of bounds by Jerome Jr. He misses. And that you have the total of 9 points. And this is a team that's 4-3 that could be looking to do a lot better.
Wow. I mean, 9 points, and we're looking at a 7-0 football team potentially here. And we've already seen Cody Endress, the quarterback, go out with a shoulder problem. Now Robert McLean, the cornerback, leaves the field. It's good to see him leaving under his own control.
Well, you get a new corner on a big guy on the bottom of your screen, Sanu. Dwayne Gratz comes into the game.
Gratz usually playing in nickel situations. Go to the right side again, and Gratz comes up and makes the tackle. Nice job. I guess that's playing assignment football, huh? Read your blocker.
Yeah, nice job. Tom Savage really audibling at the line of scrimmage, brings his wide receiver in, and in the first play on defense, Dwayne Gratz comes up and makes a nice tackle. And talk about Tom Savage regaining his momentum. He started a little bit slow, 3-for-8 for 25 yards. He's bounced back, going 6-for-6 for 90 and 1 touchdown strike.
I mentioned that Pitt game. He was 23 of 29 for 248. A touchdown in the INT, but he said he really felt comfortable in the 2-minute drill. 2nd and 9 out of the shotgun. Plenty of time again. Too much time. Another touchdown. Mark Harrison, a true freshman out of Stratford, Connecticut. Homecoming game for him. And Mike, right now, Tom Savage is looking pretty good.
Well, credit that offensive line, because as you said, plenty of time to sit back in that pocket and wait for his freshman wide receiver. You're going to watch this offensive line do an excellent job. Look at the job up top here by Anthony Davis on Lindsey Whitten. We talked about that matchup and impact players. Anthony Davis would have to have a spectacular day up front, and he gave him and the rest of that offensive line gave enough time for Tom Savage to really throw a bullet into Mark Harrison.
Sansantee for the extra points, and he drills it through. So Sansantee continues to be perfect in 2009 in the PAT department, and now Rutgers opens up a 21-10 lead, and again, we go back to Savage to Harrison.
Well, just a nice job on the in route, little motion. He's going to come down on the in route. Brown's going to clear and go to the corner, and you're going to see this offensive line give plenty of time and protection to let the freshman, who only had two catches coming into today's game. He was slowed by a groin injury, but Savage has all day to step up into the pocket, anticipate where his young receiver Harrison was going to be, and he's a huge target at 6'3". Just put it close to big number 81 and let him get in for 6 points.
Yeah, 6'3", 230. Tim Brown said this young man's going to be the next Kenny Britt at Rutgers. And those are some
That's
pretty big shoes.
Absolutely. Kenny Britt was one heck of a receiver and doing a great job in the NFL now. And if you're anytime you're mentioned in that breath, you've got something going on. And 7 plays, 64 yards. Rutgers takes 3:36 off the clock, and Savage 7 straight completions for 114 yards now and 2 touchdowns. So he's caught fire, and that confidence you said started in that pit game and that 2-minute drill. He's starting to learn on the job, and as he learns, this Rutgers offense will continue to grow.
Ball blows off the tee. Very stiff winds here inside Rentschler Field, swirling winds. You look at Savage, a true freshman. And then they have a quarterback out of Burn, South Carolina, Chaz Dodd, who's also going to Rutgers next year. And in that game on ESPNU, St. Thomas Aquinas against Burn, South Carolina, Dodd was 4-16, 3 touchdowns in that loss. So Greg Schiano with some good young players coming in at the quarterback spot.
Yeah, I was impressed by Dodd and the way he played against St. Thomas. Just a terrific job in a high school game. It was number one against number two, and number one prevailed. But Burn, South Carolina have a lot of kids on that team, and especially their quarterback that Greg Schiano is recruiting and verbally committed to Rutgers.
Maybe Dodd's watching this broadcast hoping that Savage doesn't get too comfortable. I mean, being a true freshman.
Taking a look at it, Dodd's going to have plenty of time to get experience.
As Robbie Fry hits at about the 6 or 7 yard line, and Fry is hit, and he's hit hard at the 25. So the Big East Network brings you more exciting college football action Saturday, November 7th. Coach Steve Craigthorpe and the Louisville Cardinals fly over to Mountaineer Field to take on West Virginia. And that elusive running back and number 7, Noel Devine. All the action gets underway Saturday, November 7th, noon Eastern only, right here on the Big East Network. So West Virginia, 6-2, 2-1. Tough loss last night to South Florida, but South Florida showing some defense that we didn't see last week.
Well, they showed some energy we didn't see last week. On the road playing against Pittsburgh last year, really looked like they didn't have any momentum going into that game after a tough loss at home against Cincinnati, but they sure bounced back against the Mountaineers last night.
And the player down on the field right now they're attending to is Robbie Fry, who just returned that kick. Fry with a 100-yard return earlier in the ball game, and he was hit, and he was hit hard.
May have been that left shoulder again right there. Just a huge hit by number 52. It looked like Eric LeGrand coming down on that special teams play. That was a big-time hit.
LeGrand, a 260-pounder, a sophomore from Colonial, New Jersey. And, yeah, he's definitely feeling that, holding that left arm up. So Lutris comes back, and Endress goes out. We saw McLean go out, and now Robbie Fry is banged up. Here's Cunha with his third catch of the day, just shy of the 30-yard line. Brad Cunha, the senior, said the last year he was really looking forward to big things. He had 27 catches 2 years ago. He was injured in the preseason, had high expectations. He said it was miserable, standing on the sidelines and watching for the most part. Frazier up over the middle, trying to thread the needle. He had it, but boy, that sandwich closed. Looking for Kashif Moore, number 82, the redshirt sophomore. Penalty flag drop. No, Kashif Moore is down, and he's going to get up slow now.
That was a big hit by Zaire Kitchen. Good timing in that secondary by Rutgers as UConn trying to get something going in that 2-minute drill with 1:41 left to go, and Randy Etzel facing a 21-10 deficit.
Well, coming up the half, Quint will sit down and talk with head coach Randy Etzel about the last 2 weeks in this Husky program. And as I mentioned, not to be redundant, he has been a pillar of strength. The coaches, the players, the community. And John, of course, will sit down with Lawrence Wilson, as he mentioned, and on Kenjemi's Corner. And we break down the pass rushing prowess of Lindsey Whitten. 10.5 sacks, leads the Big East Conference. That's all coming up on the Big East Halftime Reports, which is a minute 41 ago to go. Randy Edsel, his 11th season. Boy, he was amazing in the meeting yesterday, huh?
It was unbelievable, just the strength that he's shown, and you know, losing his dad in February.
Andre Dixon. There's a breakdown in communication defensively. He's all the way down to the 44-yard line. Kasim Green coming up to make the stop. A gain of 27. Dixon sneaking out of the left side.
Well, that's just a great catch by a running back coming out of the backfield. This left-handed, one-handed catch. Just a great job of concentration by Andre Dixon.
A lot of movement. Penalty flag down. And boy, the Rutgers defenders were in that backfield before the football.
71 offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
And that's the second time, Mike, that's happened. The first time ended up in an interception by Zach Frazier on a really illegal procedure. They went along with the play and get the pick, does Rutgers' defense.
Mike Ryan, redshirt sophomore out of Pennsylvania. Redshirt sophomore, redshirt freshman, redshirt sophomore, a junior and a senior, so a young offensive front, just like their defensive front. This one's complete. This time it's Isaiah Moore. Sheds a would-be tackler. That's his 19th catch of the season. He's a leading receiver on this UConn football team.
Showing some strength, trying to get the ball and get out of bounds, breaking a tackle. Although UConn has all three timeouts remaining, that was a nice play on the outside to get out of bounds and stop the clock.
Second and six, minute 26 to go. And this one goes incomplete again, looking for number 83, Isaiah Moore. And on the coverage that time, David Rowe, the sophomore from Cocoa, Florida. Remember the game we did last year, Rutgers went down to South Florida, and he was one of the few Floridians to play in that ball game, and we knew he was going to be a big-time player eventually.
I'm surprised they haven't gone back to Ryan Griffin, the tight end. After dropping the first two, he catches the third attempt his way, but he's been open in the middle of the field.
Well, we'll see what happens on third down. 3 of 8. Frazier, there he is, number 94. That's Ryan Griffin. That's his 11th catch this year. Good call, John.
It looks like he's coming up with an ankle injury.
Yeah, he's hobbling down there. This is unbelievable. The injuries continue to mount up. He just came off the injury list. John Delahunt, redshirt freshman out of Ottawa, Ontario, checks in. Frazier gets it off right before the heavy rush came, looking for Marcus Easley on the far sideline. It falls incomplete. That time, Isaiah Kitchen with the safety blitz coming in from the left side. Zach Frazier's right side, and he was coming in strong and fast.
Yeah, not a lot of room on that short side. When Greg Schiano dials up the pressure, it usually does come from the short side, and that time the safety got there just in the nick of time to make the quarterback throw an inaccurate pass.
Frazier almost picked off, again a little bit high, as he was looking for Michael Smith, the sophomore out of Houston. And that would have been the third pick for Rutgers if they had indeed pulled in the INT.
That time Rutgers not really pressuring the pocket, but Zach Frazier still had that pressure in his head on that time clock that the quarterbacks have, and may have rushed that throw a little bit.
Third and 10 for Frazier. Plenty of time, looks left, looks right, goes right, far sideline, good coverage, and it's incomplete.
A lot of contact that time by Ryan D'Imperio on the running back, Andre Dixon. Top of your screen, you're going to see the hands right there. The ball's in the air, and really no harm, no foul, but there was some hand contact along that sideline. It could have been called pass interference, and I know Dixon wanted it to be called that way.
That was Ryan D'Imperio, the middle linebacker. This one will be a 45-yard attempt by David Tigert. His long this year is 47. Yeah. And he pulls this one left. So that's the second one, opposite sides of the field, but the second one he's pulled left here in the swirling winds this afternoon at Rentschler Field.
Yeah, difficult day to really kick the football, and you can't fault the kicker on that one because it's going right into the teeth of the wind.
Celebrating its fifth year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $1.9 million in scholarship monies. 48 seconds to go before halftime. And first home game for the Huskies since the passing of their friend, teammate, football family member, Jasper Howard. They trail in the ballgame 21-10. Savage out of the shotgun, hands it off. This is Cordell Young with a rare opportunity on first down to be in the backfield. Kendall Reyes making the stop.
Kind of surprised that Rutgers, with two timeouts remaining, and they've had some success as of late throwing the football, they're going to be happy to go to the locker room 21-10. Savage doing a good job trying to bring this team back. He's been hot as of late, spreading the football around to his young receivers as well as Tim Brown and Mohamed Sanu, a freshman, another freshman on the outside, Mark Harrison with the last touchdown. So Greg Schiano did a nice job of building off of that opening kickoff return by McCourty, and their offense just waited for their offense to catch fire and has done a nice job.
Let's go downstairs now where Quinn's standing by with Greg Schiano. Obviously, some technical difficulties with the audio there, but Greg Schiano heads for the locker. Welcome back to the Big East Network Game of the Week, presented by PNC. Hartford, Connecticut. Rentschler Field, the home of the Huskies, and a lot of number six jerseys out there today, paying tribute to Jasper Howard, who lost his life 2 weeks ago. And hopefully the Huskies will end the day with a victory here to pay tribute to their number six. But right now they trail in this ballgame at 21-10. And the Huskies had won the toss. They deferred. Rutgers took the football to open things up with a 98-yard kickoff return. And now Huskies will get the ball to open up the second half. And the kick is a short one. Mike Lang at about the 18-yard line. And Lang goes down inside the 25. Good coverage as we take a look at the first half highlights, John.
Well, there's a lot of fireworks early, especially on the opening kickoff, where Devin McCourty goes 98 yards. He makes the kicker miss there, Desi Cullen, and he goes in to start the scoring. But Connecticut returns serve 100 yards. Goes Robbie Fry, gets a wall about the 25-yard line, and then outraces Devin McCourty to get in for 6 points. And then it was all the freshman quarterback for the Rutgers, Tom Savage. He finds Mark Harrison for a score at the end of the half.
First play, second half. It's Todman gets the call, hits the right side. Zach Frazier quarterbacking the Huskies. Cody Endress went down with an injury in the first half as we take a look at the numbers, John.
Well, we walked into this game and we took a look at the stats. They were very even. You see the total yards after halftime only separated by a yard, but it was the turnovers, two big turnovers by UConn and third downs. Really, Rutgers didn't do a good job on third down. They need to do a better job in the second half, but they took advantage of some momentum they built up late in that second quarter.
Endress passed for 378 last week. He was 4 for 9 for 40 yards before going out with the shoulder injury. Penalty flags drop.
29 offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
This one goes against Marcus Easley as we check in with Quinn Kesnick for the first time in the second half. Quinn.
Mike, two key injuries for Connecticut. You mentioned the quarterback situation. Cody Endress comes back out on the field with his left arm in a sling. The second significant injury is Robbie Fry, kick returner, scored UConn's only touchdown today. He is done for the day also. Robert McClain, the cornerback, will be back. He's got a bruised quad, but he was testing it out before the start of the second half. And one thing from field level, guys, the wind gusts continue.
Thanks, Quint. The injuries mount up. Of course, we saw Ryan Griffin, the big tight end, limping late in that first half as well. Here's Frazier out of the shotgun. And this one's almost picked off, but number 94, Ryan Griffin, who I just mentioned, back on the field and pulls in the catch.
Boy, great job by Ryan Griffin. He knew he was going to take a shot over the middle by Munoz, the linebacker, but fought right through the throw. And a good anticipation by Zach Frazier, trusting that his tight end would come up with the football, and it puts him in a nice third and four situation.
Well, the story on UConn earlier, they play like a top 25 team for three quarters, and the roof falls in. Now they're trying to switch it around here in this ball game. Get something going here in the second half as Frazier overshoots his man, Brad Cunyu. Cunyu looks at the official saying, hey, I was interfered with. He said that Billy Anderson was all over me that time, but no flag on the play, and it's going to bring up a punting situation for the Huskies.
Yeah, collision with Brad Cunyu towards the Rutgers sideline. No penalty was called, and on that play, Zach Frazier looked a little bit rattled in the backfield. He wanted to go outside, but really had no pressure, didn't go down, and just threw it away, so that'll bring on the punting unit.
Cullen will be punting to Mohamed Sanyu. Inside the 30, gets over the 30, dropped it about the 32 by Mike Lang. Let's take a look now at our Big East leaders, brought to you by PNC, leading the way.
Yeah, the sack leaders, Lindsey Witten. You see 10.5 sacks, doing a great job from UConn. And Greg Romeus has had an excellent year for the Pitt Panthers up front.
Jonathan
Freeney there for Rutgers as well in this game.
I see Greg Romeus there with 7. I thought he did such a good job of staying home last week against USF. And last night, B.J. Daniels getting outside of that contain against West Virginia. Martinick on the carry. Those were the total sacks so far in 2009. 10.5 for Lindsey Witten. Last year, Cody Brown and Connor Barwin of Cincinnati tied for the lead with 11. So you can see Witten, 3 sacks against Ohio in the opener, 4 against Carolina. Then he got hit with a flu bug. And about 10.5 so far this year. Pretty good numbers here as we just wrap up the month of October. Martinick stays in the backfield behind Tom Savage. Martinick gets the call, finds a little bit of running room, and he's up over the 40. Greg Loy, the middle linebacker, making the stop.
Well, this is the identity that Rutgers would like to have on offense. They'd like to line up and just really get those offensive linemen moving that line of scrimmage down the field. And that's what Greg Schiano wants to show, some toughness. He wants to show that toughness in between the tackles, and he wants his running backs to go north and south. And it all starts up front. I thought Tom Savage on the last play did a nice job, little check with me run. He had it going one way, went back to the left side, and was successful on second down.
Out of the I formation, Corcoran, the lead back. This is Martinick, and he's got some of that toughness you talked about. I mean, he had 79 of his 139 yards in the fourth against Army in that victory last week. And right now, so what's the difference between Martinick and maybe a Brooks? And he said, not much. They're both good, but maybe a little
consistent. I think consistency is the biggest thing, and productivity. I think as the game goes along, Joe Martinick's able to be more productive, and he's sure hands. He doesn't fumble the football, and he runs north and south. And I think you can trust him in a game in the second half.
-2 for Martinick in the first half. 19 on this drive so far for Joe Martinick. 11:03 to go in the third quarter. Rutgers on top, 21-10. Martinick hits the left side. He breaks a lot of tackles. He's inside the 45. Now Robert Vaughn finally brings him down.
The one thing about Joe Martinick is that the first guy really doesn't bring him down. He continues to move those legs. 7 rushes for 21 yards. Not doing anything spectacular, but last week against Army, he had 82 of those yards of 147 in the fourth quarter. So this is a guy that gets better as the game goes along and he gets more touches.
He's listed at 215, John. When he runs with the football, it looks more like 225.
Yeah, he does.
Savage going deep, looking, and almost had his man. That was Mohamed Sanu, the freshman out of South Brunswick. And it falls incomplete.
Well, after running it on consecutive plays, Bleedy Wilson, the cornerback, comes over from the wide side of the field. Just a nice play action fake, but from the right side of your screen, you're going to see Bleedy Wilson come out of nowhere, and he does a nice job of challenging the football. And you can see the wind play havoc with that ball as it came down. It went away from Mohamed Sanu, and he really couldn't make a play on the football.
Savage, true freshman, facing a third and six at the 43. Felt the pressure that time, a little bit high on the throw. So much time in the first half to throw in that pocket. This time, that pocket collapsed a little bit, and it was number nine, Lindsey Whitten, getting in on him.
Yeah, that was a good job. That time, the battle at the line of scrimmage was won by the Huskies, and it led by Lindsey Whitten, doing a nice job of pressuring the pocket and forcing Tom Savage. Really couldn't follow through on that throw, and he was a little bit high and outside on third down.
Teddy Delagano. Big first half. 350 or 50 plus punts. Robert McClain standing back at the 10-yard line. Delagana aiming to put the ball inside the 20-yard line. It goes out of bounds. Depending on the spot, it'll be close to the 25.
Well, he's going to get a talking to a little bit on the sidelines from Greg Schiano, because on the first half he knocked one in the end zone, which was an easy kick. And now he's saying, just keep it in bounds. We want to pin him down because we've got the lead at 21-10.
Inside 10 minutes now, quarter number three here in Hartford, 21-10. Rutgers on top of the Huskies of UConn. Number six, in memory of Jasper Howard, the fallen teammates, the junior out of Miami. He would have had a year to go, and Randy Edsall had a good thought he'd play in the National Football League if he had given the chance. Zach Frazier goes back to work. Here's Marcus Easley with a catch. Easley with back-to-back-to-back 100-yard games. Gets up to the 35. We go downstairs with Quinn.
Mike, there is significant news here in Connecticut this week. Four arrests were made on Tuesday in connection with the murder of Jasper Howard. The University of Connecticut police, in conjunction with the state police, arresting four on Tuesday. And I talked to Randy Edsall about it. He says he was encouraged to see that the process was working. Used the term closure and used the term moving on. And I think that's what everyone on campus yesterday in our time there really wanted to do. They would just want to continue to move things forward.
And Quint, Randy Edsall, long before this tragedy happened, in some of our meetings 2 weeks ago, he talked about the fact that he tells his guys always strive to play hard, to play like it's your last play you'll make. And he brought that up in the meeting, that Jasper Howard did just that. His final game against Louisville, 11 tackles, forced fumble. Big, big game for number six, Jasper Howard. Frazier lofts it up, and this one's complete to Todman. Todman inside the 30-yard line, finally driven out, close to a penalty flag. Zaire Kitchen, he was out of bounds, but he still rode him to the ground. A gain of 41 that time, JC.
Well, in the first half, we saw Andre Dixon make a great catch, but you're going to see the wheel route out of the backfield again. This is just a perfect throw by Zach Frazier. He made a nice throw earlier to Andre Dixon on this wheel route. Now he makes it to Jordan Todman. And as you said, Mike, it could have been an extra 15 yards for that tackle out of bounds. I'm surprised the official was right there. I'm surprised he didn't call it.
You mentioned Andre Dixon was all alone. That time, Todman, the coverage was better, but better pass that time,
better
too.
Pass, yeah. Good throw beats good coverage all the time. And that time, Zach Frazier threw it on the dime. And he's going to have to play well in this third and fourth quarter to get UConn back in this football game, because it looks like Rutgers is doing a nice job shutting down the running game. Zach Frazier is going to be asked to sit back in that pocket, battle some adversity and some pressure and heat in that pocket, and make a play.
Player down on the field for Rutgers is Zaire Kitchen, who's battled three knee surgeries, and we'll take a timeout as they attend to him.
What do you want, Haggardus?
I want to take Monday off for Chinchilla Day.
I've never heard of Chinchilla Day.
It commemorates the defenders of a tiny French village. Outnumbered and outsized, the courageous musketeers managed to defeat the badly behaved rogues.
How do you celebrate?
My people party in Vegas.
Hey, Vincent!
Go State!
Hey, Ham.
Why did that guy call you Vincent?
Because that's my real name, Bergwood.
It is? How do you know that?
He's my Allstate agent.
Oh, he insures your car.
And my boat.
You got a boat?
Ugh, my wife is a big-time skier.
You're married?
Allstate agents know who you really are and help you save money by combining your car insurance with home, boat, and more. Are you in good hands?
Where'd you meet your wife?
Pilates.
She's European.
A few quick clicks and you found the directions you needed or that recipe you wanted. And now, just one click gets you everything you need to advance your career and increase your salary. Earn My Degree features hundreds of online degrees. And with 24/7 online convenience, you can earn your degree whenever, wherever you like, in as little as 10 months. So all you have to do is click. Visit Earn My Degree today. Go to the web address on your screen right now.
John Mapes is 42. Mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $15 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
Back in Hartford, that last pass play before the commercial break goes 41 yards. So now the Huskies inside the 25-yard line, trailing 21-10, 8:39 to go in the third quarter. Oh! Frazier dropped the football out of the shotgun, and Todman's going down back at the 31. Big gain, shoot themselves in the foot.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, one step forward, two steps back today for this UConn offense, and Zach Frazier just fumbles the shotgun snap. Luckily, Todman gets on the football, and nothing worse happens than a 5 or 6 yard loss on the play. So they come back out with trips to the field and see how they can do on second and long.
Frazier named the starter before the season started. He got banged up. Cody Endress was really evolving into a nice quarterback. He went out with a shoulder injury earlier in the ball game. Frazier fires, has his man near the 10. It's going to fall incomplete. That's Isaiah Moore. Good coverage by Rutgers, but Moore couldn't hang on.
Yeah, Moore tried to climb the ladder and get the football. The ball was pretty well thrown and on time by Zach Frazier, a corner route on the inside. It looked like Dwayne Difton had the in route on the inside. This ball is thrown pretty close to on target. I mean, you can't throw a better ball than that. He beats the coverage with the throw, and it's one of those that Isaiah Moore needs to make. Tough plays in situations in second and long. Now you get in third and 16, and it's very difficult.
Frazier fires. This one's picked off, his third. David Rohl. 30, 35, and he's hit and driven out of bounds by a very irate Mike Hicks, the right tackle. Or check it, that's Zach Hurd, the redshirt junior, 6'7", 315 pounds. David Rogo, 6'1", 195. That's a third INT of Frazier here today.
Well, he came into the game with four INTs, did Zach Frazier, but this ball's thrown high and well behind. It looked like the intended receiver was Dwayne Difton coming, but there's no chance for any of the receivers wearing blue jerseys to catch this one. This ball had no chance, and it went directly to David Rowe on the outside, and he makes a play to get the ball back up to the 35-yard line. But UConn had an opportunity there with a catch on second down to be in scoring position. Now Rutgers gets the football back.
Yeah, they were just outside that red zone. A touchdown would have made it 21-17. But now Savage goes back to work the other way. True freshman, 6'5", 230. He's dragged down. That's going to be a horse collar on number 9, Lindsey Witten. Witten throws out his arms. Hey, I'm just tackling the guy. Got to bring down the big guy somehow. But, of course, that is against the rules now. As of last year, no horse collar.
Personal foul. Horse collar. 9 on the defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Take another look. That right hand right behind Tom Savage's nameplate drags him down, and that's not a real severe one, but that still is a penalty. Just trying to make the right play and the aggressive play and trying to bring the big quarterback down. He goes 6'5", 230, so you're trying to grab anything you can wearing number seven.
Back when you played, they could horse collar, right?
And they could do a lot worse than that, I believe, yeah. You see me walk out of this press box.
Sanu in motion to the top of your screen. Savage, Martinick. Martinick is hit immediately by Jesse Joseph, a true freshman, calling his name and number a lot here this afternoon.
Yeah, Jesse Joseph. I thought Gervardo Williams and Jesse Joseph for UConn on that defensive end have played a really nice game. They've done a good job in containing Joe Martinick in that running game. But that defensive front needs to step up now. They need to create a turnover, tackle the football, do something that gets some momentum back on that UConn sideline.
Well, the Huskies we mentioned at halftime, Lindsey Witten, the number one sack artist in the Big East. Lawrence Wilson, number one in tackles in the Big East. McLean and Vaughn with four INTs each. That's number one in the Big East. Now here comes the pressure. Savage spins out of it. And Twan Martin finally brings him down behind the line of scrimmage. So that goes down as a sack along with Greg Lloyd.
And Mike, it all started with number 32, who's back in the game, Scott Lutris. He came to the wide side of the field from that linebacker spot and really forced the pocket. Watch him come to the outside. The tackle can only take one, and that really frees up somebody on the inside. And Greg Lloyd coming inside, it flushes him to Twan Martin, who ends up getting the sack. So it's all set up by Lutris on the outside and Greg Lloyd coming on the inside.
Third sack of the day. That gives UConn 23 for the season. Third and 11, it's hit at the line of scrimmage and falls incomplete, looking for Sanu. So that's going to bring up a punting situation for Rutgers, and the Huskies of UConn, with 5:43 to go in the third quarter, will get the football back.
Yeah, that's a nice defensive stand after that personal foul on Lindsey Witten that gave him an extra 15 yards. Rutgers moving the football, but Frazier will have another opportunity to get back out and try to control the football, control the passing game. Only down by 11. They don't need a lot out of this drive, but they do need to get field position. They need to create some kind of momentum on that Husky sideline.
Delegana with a short field again. His last punt went 15 yards. This one stays in bounds and hits at about the 6-yard line, and it's going to be down at about the 1, 1.5. Good coverage, good punt. Devin McCourty, number 21. He's been all over the field today, starting with that opening kickoff of 98. That's a 42-yard punt, 21-10. Rutgers still on top.
Economy's been a little rough, man.
Oh, man, just brutal.
You know, it's times like these that E-Trade can really help you replan your investments.
Yep.
So, you know, it gives you the tools and research.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Take control. Rise up.
Dude,
No.
What?
Stop.
What, I can't flex the golden pipes?
It's not the venue.
It's inspirational.
Any place.
Fine.
Okay, where was
I'm
I?
I'm going to fly again.
Take control with one of the most powerful investing machines there is. Join the 1,000 new accounts a day at E-Trade.
Ready? Go get it.
Don?
What? We don't need these minutes anymore. We got that calling circle thing everybody else has.
It's AT&T's A-List, Don, and it's not the same. We get unlimited calls to any 10 people on any network. But unlike everyone else, the minutes we save, we keep.
So
why save minutes with your calling circle if they just expire at the end of the month? You're using that one.
Introducing A-List with rollover. Unlimited calling to any 10 numbers on any network and keep the minutes you save. Only from AT&T.
Looking for twice the thrill? At half the bill? Think Puerto Rico. Come to Puerto Rico and get two free nights when you stay two nights. Plus great discounts on sailing, snorkeling, hiking, sightseeing, and walking tours. You just can't afford to let this thrill pass you by. Book it today with your favorite travel partner. Puerto Rico, no passport required for U.S. citizens.
I did actually look at a couple other sites, but they kind of seemed like a digital version of a bar.
It just didn't seem to be really effective.
Other dating sites just give you a picture and a paragraph. At eHarmony, we match you with pre-screened singles based on 29 dimensions of compatibility, proven to be the foundation for happy, long-term relationships.
It didn't seem as shallow like some of the other websites.
That was the beautiful thing about eHarmony, that you can go much deeper.
Experience the eHarmony difference for yourself. Review all your matches for free at eHarmony.com.
Welcome back to Hartford and our Big East Network Game of the Week presented by PNC. Rutgers and the Huskies of UConn here at Rentschler Field along with John Congemi, Quinn Kesnick. I'm Mike Gleason. As always, great to have you with us. You look at the series, Rutgers leading at 19-9, but again, you go back to the all those games decided six of the last seven by 10 points or less, three of those games by 2 points or less. As Cody Endres stands on that sideline in that sling. And today's first and 10 line is brought to you by Overstock.com. A lot of green in front of Zach Frazier and the UConn Huskies now, but 5:33 to go in the third quarter. They need some points. Touchdown cuts it to four. Andre Dixon weaves his way through traffic all the way out to the 10-yard line. And we go downstairs with Quint.
Mike, the sense you get down here on this Connecticut sideline, and I've talked to a bunch of people who cover this UConn team on a weekly basis. They were in West Virginia last week. They sense, and I sense, that this team's a little emotionally drained right now. You know, they've been through the ringer in the last 2 weeks. You have to wonder how much, you know, gas is still left in that tank emotionally. And now is the time.
Well, Dixon has some gas right now. He's up over the 40, but a penalty flag dropped at the 15. But that is a great point that Quint brings up. I didn't want to go there at first in the first half because you figure dealing with the death, first of all, losing the way they did to West Virginia, the entire team flies down on a charter to Miami to go attend the funeral on Monday. They turn around, fly all the way back. And I was going to ask you earlier if I thought, you know, is it possible this team could become emotionally spent?
Absolutely, it could be.
Holding, 79 offense. Half the distance to the goal, second down.
You know, Mike, after the last 13 or 14 days, you know, in talking with head coach Randy Edsel and talking about the mood of the team, the mood of the community, you know, absolutely, it's a big draining day to come back here. You know, you're after the initial emotion wears off, you know, you're still out here playing a football game and you've got nothing left in the tank sometimes. And that was a huge play that's going to be called back for Randy Edsel in this offense because they just started to get some momentum on the ground. Andre Dixon, a nice gain on first down. Now they bring it back and they'll have second and medium, but that was a big gain brought back for the Huskies.
Covered 35 yards. The infraction went against Mike Hicks, the tackle. And it's Dixon again, just shy of the 10-yard line as Devin McCourty, number 21's having a big, big game. He's all over the field here today.
Yeah, he started the game with that 98-yard kickoff return. Now defensively, he's done a nice job of making some tackles, making some big plays for the Scarlet Knights on defense, and they bring up a third and three, but McCourty's been a leader on that edge, the senior.
Greg Schiano trying to push his team to their sixth win in 2009, pick up their first Big East victory. Frazier, this one will be incomplete. Good pressure by the Scarlet Knights again. The intended receiver, Kashif Moore, but now some of the Bluebirds are coming up. As Zach Frazier with three picks continues to struggle.
Yeah, three picks on the afternoon, but they don't boo if they don't hold on second down and get that 35-yarder called back because that'd give them instant field position.
Well, moments ago, the Huskies were knocking on the door of being in the red zone, and now field position really shifting now as Mohamed Sanu standing on his 45. You see Cullen will be punting this one from his end zone. Cullen, number two in the Big East at 43-6. They could use a big one here. Sanu at the 38, drops it. Finds a little bit of an opening up. He gets up over the 50-yard line inside Husky territory. Well, the best in women's basketball are set to hit the stage at the ESPNU Road to the Championship held in San Antonio. That'll be November 17th. Watch the national champion UConn Huskies battle Texas and the Lady Vols of Tennessee battle Texas Tech. For tickets, call 1-800-745-3000 or visit ESPNUroadtothechampionship.com for more details. Lady Huskies, that team, just about every one of the Lady Huskies touched by Jasper Howard. Jasper used to play in pickup games against a lot of these ladies in the summertime. And the defending national champions here on the sidelines this afternoon as they honor number six, Jasper Howard. There's Joe Martinick now, puts his head down and picks up one maybe. And you look at the UConn women's basketball team, sixth NCAA title, 17 Big East titles, and the Big East, pretty good conference for women's basketball.
Yeah, absolutely. Final four appearances, 10. I mean, just done a terrific job as Gino in that women's basketball program, and last year they were a pleasure to watch.
There they are. Lady Huskies ready to defend that national championship. Basketball season is, well, football and basketball, they always overlap, and once we get into mid-October, that basketball season comes on fast. Martinick hits that line of scrimmage fast, but not too much running room. Penalty flag dropped right at the 50. Lawrence Wilson making the stop for UConn.
May get a holding penalty here or a tripping penalty. Looked like Witten was complaining.
Personal foul. 19 on the defense. Tripping. 15-yard penalty. Second down.
It looked like that was going on Corrigan, number 19, the fullback for Rutgers, tripping Lindsey Witten on the edge.
Corcoran, the 6'1", 230-pound senior out of Atlantic City, New Jersey. Saw him last year, a couple of touchdown receptions, one touchdown reception this year. They're not going to him as much as they used to. Mike Teal used to find his fullback a lot coming out of the backfield.
Yeah, when you had a guy like a couple years back, like Leonard, who's moved on to the NFL, that guy was do it all every down.
Yeah, Leonard, one of those guys to play fullback or tailback in college, huh?
Yeah, he was terrific. He could run the football as well as his block and catch.
This one's complete to the tight end, Shamar Graves. His first catch of the afternoon, his eighth of the season. Started the season as the starter. Moved aside for the big freshman, D.C. Jefferson.
Good job by Lawrence Wilson on Shamar Graves, number three there. He came into the game with seven catches for 70 yards. And as you said, D.C. Jefferson moved into that tight end role with a former quarterback now playing tight end for the Scarlet Knights. But a third and long now for freshman Tom Savage, who he's been really quiet in the second half, going to Tim Brown and Mohamed Sanu.
Twins at the top and bottom of your screen. Savage takes off himself. He's hit and hit hard at the 45. Lawrence Wilson really laid out the big young freshman quarterback that time. He's going to be shy of that first down. So he's a fourth down. Greg Schiano, does he kick it? They keep going. There's a minute 39 to go in the third quarter.
Well, if it's me, the way they played the second half, right at the end of the half, they went ahead and played very conservative. So I would go ahead and send my punting unit out and let and see if Randy Etzel, who's had some struggles with his backup quarterback so far in this football game by turning the football over, try to create that long field for them to play on.
Delegano with the short field again. McLean again at the 10. And again, a short punt. This one's going to hit at about the 21-yard line, and that's where it's going to be down. Andrew DePaula coming up to down that football. The Big East Network brings you more exciting college football action Saturday, November 7th. Steve Craigthorpe and the Louisville Cardinals fly over to Mountaineer Field to take on West Virginia. And that elusive running back, Noel Devine. All the action gets underway Saturday, November 7th, from Morgantown at noon, only right here on the Big East Network. And the Louisville Cardinals trying to get something going here this year for Steve Craigthorpe as well. And over in Cincinnati today at halftime, I'm not sure where it is now on the bottom line, or but it was 14-7. Cincinnati was leading Syracuse by just one touchdown.
Yeah, I think it was back up to 20.
And John Kettering, our producer, informs us it is 14-7 as Todman takes off. Rutgers stretched it out, but they did pick up 12 yards on the game. That'll move the chains. UConn Lady Huskies trying to rally the football troops, get some points, need some instant offense now. But just 54 seconds to go before we move into the final 15 minutes.
They need more than some threes right now. They need to get some sixes on the scoreboard. And that's exactly how they're going to start it. Only 11 down. They need to continue to run the football.
Zach Frazier looking and missing, overshooting Michael Smith again.
know, sometimes, Mike, when you come in as the backup quarterback, and I know we're deep into the third quarter, almost in the fourth, but nothing simulates game time experience. You can go through practice and you can take your reps, but when most of the time, you know, in practice, the starter, Cody Indris, is going to get most of those reps. And you really can't simulate that stuff at practice, the speed of the game. And sometimes you either have it or you don't. Right now, Zach Frazier's trying to find it.
And John, an update on that Cincinnati game. It was 14-7 at half. Now it's 28-7. Bearcats on top. Todman moving the chains. Another first down. So that's that running game, the bread and butter for UConn. As they try to stay in the game, he picks up 14 more on the play.
That's what UConn needs to do right now. The crowd's going to get back into it in the fourth quarter. They need to run the football. And this is a great job of hitting the hole. Just a nice crack back by the outside, but hitting that hole. That's what Randy Edsall said last week against West Virginia, as Todman gets up and he's okay after that big bounce on his forehead.
9 for 60 for Todman now as Frazier goes back to the air. And again, he... Well, Moore, tough catch because it was thrown a little bit beyond his outstretch. Look at this. They say there's a hold on every play. You didn't see it.
Well, Todman's lucky he didn't injure his neck or his head right there, because that's a dangerous way that Todman fell down after being toppled by Green, the free safety. But they're going to have to run the football. They're only down by 11 points with a quarter left to go.
Todman remains in the backfield for the Huskies. Final play of the third quarter now. Frazier fires down the middle and overshoots his receiver. That's Marcus Easley, and actually overshot the secondary. Joe Lefebvre says, hey, take a little bit off. I would have had another
pick. It was a good thing that was overthrown, because Lefebvre was in a perfect spot for the interception.
So we have 15 minutes of football left here from Hartford. And again, they're paying tribute to Jasper Howard, but right now the Scarlet Knights on top, 21-10.
We think alike.
Even when he thought he might lose his job.
Now let me get back to work.
All right, I'll catch you later.
He says he doesn't think about it much. But I don't believe him. I think he does it for us. Sometimes doing the right thing is just making people happy.
Women's Hoops fans, this is your opportunity to see the best in the nation compete at the AT&T Center.
UConn has done it again.
Texas Tech takes on Pat Summitt and the feisty Tennessee squad. Plus, Gail Gesternkors and Texas are competing for their 24th trip to the NCAA tourney. Sit courtside as they battle to knock off the defending national champion Huskies. The road to the championship starts here. Get your tickets today by calling 210-224-9600.
This is the information retailers don't want you to know, especially now. They don't want you to learn just how much money you've been giving away to retail markups on items you purchase for your home, all because you don't know how to buy like the insiders do at Direct Buy Club, the home improvement and furnishings club with direct insider prices.
The best thing about Direct Buy is you're getting the best price that you can, and it's very easy to go shopping at Direct Buy.
I've purchased coffee pot, toaster, blender, food processor, all of those things. The savings is significant. It truly is.
And now, for the first time ever, Direct Buy is offering you a certificate for a free 30-day membership. Members buy top quality name brand merchandise from hundreds and hundreds of trusted manufacturers. So call the number on your screen now and we'll rush you your free visitor's pass to your local Direct Buy Club and your certificate for a free 30-day membership. This is a limited offer, so call now. No dealers, please.
How can I tell my girlfriend's bra size?
Maybe you should ask someone.
Oh, good idea.
I got this one. You take your hands.
Actually, the best way is to compare them to a piece of fruit. Are they apples, oranges, or grapefruits?
They're melons.
I have those.
Text your question to 542-542. How do you like them apples?
Those are grapefruits.
First home game for the Huskies since losing their beloved teammate, Jasper Howard. How about the Tampa Bay Bucks now? Howard, a very, very special, special teams player, a punt returner, and the Tampa Bay Bucks special teams all writing personal notes to Randy Edsall and the Huskies, and Edsall sharing those with the team, bringing them down to the funeral in Miami.
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, just the way it was handled from start to finish, what a tragedy for all these young men to go through and the family of Jasper Howard, but for the show the resilience of a staff and a community to come back and try to put closure to the whole tragic situation.
Here comes the heat, and Zach Frazier finds his big tight end, Zach Ryan Griffin. He had the ball, dropped it, but that should be a completed ball. A gain of five, maybe six on the play. So if you joined us late here, it's the first home game for the Huskies, and Cody Endress, who passed for over 378 against West Virginia, went out after hitting four of nine passes here today, went out with a shoulder injury. There he is with the sling on his left arm. Zach Frazier's come on, and he's thrown three picks here today. He's really struggled.
Yeah, Mike, and in the third quarter, he's 3 for 10 for 57 yards and one interception. So, you know, it's one of those things where you have to be able to get back up and try to find a way to rally your team.
5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Well, the Huskies going to push it 5 yards deeper for Randy Edsall, and Desi Collin will kick it, but that'll give Mohamed Sanu a little bit more breathing room down near his goal line. He's standing at about the 10-yard line right now. Sanu, when you look at that guy, he was recruited as a safety, now playing wide receiver, true freshman, 6'2", 215. They said the speed of the game never really bothered him. That's the kind of athlete he is. And this one goes out of bounds off the side of the foot of Desi Collin. Let's go back and check out Cody Endress trying to set up the screen ball. Comes down on his left shoulder hard.
Yeah, came down on his left shoulder. You could tell right away he was injured. They walk him in, comes back out with a sling, and then it's been downhill for Zach Frazier with the pick early to Munoz over the middle, and then a bad snap, an early snap, and another pick to Joe Lefege over the middle, and then one to David Rowe, which was well behind and overthrown two Connecticut wide receivers. So the injury to Cody Endress, who had been rolling as of late the last couple of games, you know, you go into Zach Frazier, who hasn't played in a couple of weeks, coming off an injury.
Martinick gets the call. Those three interceptions for Rutgers, giving them 11 on the year. And you see UConn, the three interceptions, the penalty 7 for 57. They average about four penalties a game and two missed field goals in the swirling wind here at Rentschler.
Yeah, it looks like a mass unit on the sidelines for Connecticut, because they've had a number of players go out, nicks and bruises and shoulder injuries. And, you know, it's just one of those things where you're coming back and you're playing a physical football game against a physical team that likes to run the football downhill.
Second and nine for Savage out of the shotgun. Fires. That's a completed pass that was just simply dropped by Mark Harrison, the true freshman from Stratford, Connecticut. He does have a touchdown. You'd mentioned earlier that he came into the game with just two catches, but those two catches averaging 24 yards.
Penalties declined. Third down.
Anthony Davis, the potentially first-round pick of the NFL draft, caught for holding that time.
And Rutgers will get back on the line of scrimmage. And you don't see many drop passes by the guys in white jerseys. That time he did on second down. So third and long, facing the young freshman Tom Savage at quarterback.
.13-22 to go in the ball game.
I'd come right back to him. The freshman has a single coverage on the short side against a cornerback, Dwayne Gratz, who's in for Robert McClain.
Trips to the top of your screen. He comes to the bottom, near side. That's Sanu. He stretched out, and depending on the mark, they're going to spot it at about the 29-yard line. It's going to be a yard shy of the first down.
I like the thinking of Tom Savage. He was looking to the field side all the way, but he knew he had single coverage on the short side. He could come back late to it. And watch him. He's going to look to the field, but now he feels a little bit of pressure. That clock's coming. He steps up and throws a bullet to the short side to the freshman Sanu, but just a yard short, and that'll bring on the punting unit.
So Savage heads for the sidelines, and Teddy Delagana back on the field for the Scarlet Knights. Low spiral kick. McClain thought about it, and then he backed off. A wise decision. I think the wind grabbed that, John, and kind of took off.
Absolutely it did.
53-yard punt for Delagana. And a very important series, important decisions coming up now for the UConn Huskies.
So much craziness. Visit Overstock.com and find everything that you want with name brand products at up to 70% off every day.
When all my faith has gone, you bring it back to me. You make it real for me.
Your entire order ships for just $2.95. Overstock.com, at home with the O.
The Ohio State University.
The University of Texas.
Southern University.
California, Berkeley.
Old Dominion University.
Harvard University.
The University of Virginia.
Texas A&M.
Norfolk State University.
Georgia University.
Arizona State.
Pennsylvania State University.
The few, the proud, the Marines.
The Big East Network brings you more exciting college football action Saturday, November 7th, when Coach Steve Craigthorpe and the Louisville Cardinals fly over to Mountaineer Field to take on West Virginia and their dynamic running back, Noel Devine, a threat to go the distance on any given play. Can the Cardinals slow down and contain the Mountaineers' elusive 5'8 running back, or will Devine continue to evade defenders and propel his team to victory? All the action gets underway Saturday, November 7th at noon Eastern, only on the Big East Network.
At Barron's, we find investing opportunities that the crowd missed and give you investing ideas and insights that can help your portfolio grow. Subscribe now and you'll receive 8 weeks of Barron's plus Barron's Online with access to daily columns, market analysis, and tools like our Stock Screener and Market Lab, all for only $19.95. Call now, 800-334-6600. That's 800-334-6600 for Barron's.
College basketball returns to Madison Square Garden as four top 25 teams kick off the season in the 2K Sports Classic benefiting Coaches versus Cancer November 19th and 20th. North Carolina will look to defend their national title against powerhouses Syracuse, Ohio State, and Cal. Tickets start at just $10 and are available by phone through Ticketmaster.com or our Garden box office. Follow all of the action at CoachesVersusCancer.com. Don't miss your chance to see the 2009 national champion Tar Heels at the Garden as part of the 2K Sports Classic benefiting Coaches versus Cancer.
Back in Hartford, there you see the time. That's critical. 13 minutes to go, 21-10. Zach Frazier, well, he's had a rough day, but there's still time to pull this one out.
Absolutely. Zach Frazier can still be the hero of this football game with 13:04 left to go. He needs a solid running game, but he's going to have to really start to revive some good memories in throwing the football.
Swings it out. High percentage pass. Todman gets it in the flat. And he's still on his feet up to the 20-yard line as Devin McCourty, number 21, in on the play once again.
It almost looked like Todman stepped out of bounds around the 15-yard line. The official was right there, said he didn't, and he was able to continue on and make a positive gain out of something that looked like it was going to be a loss of yards. Take another look at this. Watch his right foot close to the sideline around the 15-yard line. It looked like, at first glance, he may have stepped out.
Oh, very close. If he didn't, it was awfully close. Frazier out of the gun again. Fires. Finds his man. That's Difton, the true freshman out of St. Thomas Aquinas, up over the 30-yard line. Kasim Green makes the tackle. A gain of 12 on the play.
Tough catch for the freshman, Dwayne Difton, but makes a nice catch and run to move the chains.
Today's first and 10 line is brought to you by Overstock.com. Clock is running 12:09, down 21-10. Todman gets two, three maybe. Clock continues to run inside 12 minutes now. And Todman or Andre Dixon break off a long run.
Somebody needs to step up here, Mike, and be the hero to get them back in this football game. Only down 11 with 11:43 and counting. Somebody needs to keep this drive alive because they need some type of score in this drive.
Marcus Easley at the top of your screen, coming off of three straight 100-yard receiving games. Frazier looking, and some miscommunication. I'm not sure if that was for Difton or Kashif Moore. Moore turned to the inside. The ball came to the outside where Difton was.
Well, that time Zach Frazier missed a wide-open tight end in Ryan Griffin. I think Rutgers busted a coverage. He was trying to go outside, but Ryan Griffin was all by himself. He's going to walk down the middle of this football field. They just bust a coverage, does Rutgers, and nobody in this entire area was covering the tight end.
All right, John, third down and seven. If Rutgers gets the football, obviously they start eating clock with that running game. Frazier trying to move some change now. Third and seven. Backfield.
And they're going to bring some heat from the field.
Here comes the heat. There's the pass over the middle, and it's caught. Nice catch by Ryan Griffin. 6'6", 240. Gain of 23, and they move the chains.
Well, the play before, there wasn't any white shirts around. This time, there's probably two or three flying around Ryan Griffin, and he comes up with the football. Nice job by Zach Frazier, hanging tough in the pocket, took a big shot, but his tight end, the 6'6", 240. Watch the quarterback, Zach Frazier, take the shot on the short side of the field, but showed some toughness and courage to stay in there, throw the football up, and give his tight end an opportunity.
Griffin dropped that big second and 21 on the last drive last week at West Virginia. Here comes Dixon. Dixon close to the 30-yard line at about the 31, and the Huskies are on the move. 10 minutes and 50 seconds to go, 11 more yards.
Well, they just needed one play to add some spark to this offense, and I think Ryan Griffin did that on third down, and it's backed up by a tough run by Andre Dixon.
Randy Edsall, head coach of the Huskies. Frazier almost picked off, and again, number 21, Devin McCourty. And he's going to hear from his brother, Jason. He's going to get a phone call saying, what are you doing? How can you be a cornerback and not hold on to that one?
Well, that one was, it was stared at the entire time. Zach Frazier was staring this one down. It's cover two, meaning the corner's press coverage, and the safety's going to come off the hash mark if the quarterback stares there too long. And that was a tight, tight window to try to fit that in.
Second and 10 from the gun. Frazier over the middle. Easley bounces to the outside. Easley, another touchdown. Huskies 32 yards. Kasim Green, the free safety, thought he had him. He just bounced off the would-be tackle.
Well, that's the drive the UConn Huskies needed. We talked about it a couple of minutes ago. They just needed to put together a drive, come down, get some type of plays, some type of momentum. Ryan Griffin provided that with a big third down catch for Randy Edsall's team. And Zach Frazier this time hits Marcus Easley coming from right to left for a touchdown. Nice job of good protection in the pocket. Nobody near quarterback Zach Frazier. Look at this explosiveness. Breaks the tackle about the 15-yard line. Easley's a big guy at 6'2", 216. He possesses great speed, and the UConn Huskies are back in this one.
And they're going for two. Down 21-16 with 10-plus on the clock. Frazier throws it, and it's complete to Ryan.
What a catch.
Mike Ryan, 6'5", 324 with hands. Next week, he's going to ask Coach Edsall if he could play receiver.
Maybe Coach Calhoun on the basketball. That looked like a layup. What a great job by Mike Ryan.
You know, John, I don't know if he's happy or shocked. He can't take his
helmet off. Probably both. What a great athletic play by the sophomore. 6'5", 324 pounds. Watch him first show the great soft hands, and now watch him lay out about the 3-yard line doing his Reggie Bush impersonation going over the sideline. Just a great job on the 2-point conversion. Unbelievable on the scoreboard. It's unbelievable. Watch the big fella get up and over for the 2-point conversion. UConn closes the gap 21-18.
Nice.
It's time. From the number one maker of ATVs and side-by-sides comes the 70-horsepower Sportsman 850 XP. The new Ranger 800 XP with 15% more power. And the all-new workhorse, the midsize Ranger 400. Polaris, hardest working, smoothest riding.
Hey, Vincent!
Go State!
Hey, Ham, why did that guy call you Vincent?
Because that's my real name, Bergwood.
It is? How do you know that?
He's my Allstate agent.
Oh, he insures your car.
And my boat.
You got a boat?
My wife is a big-time skier.
You're married?
Allstate agents know who you really are and can help you save money by combining your car insurance with home, boat, and more. Are you in good hands?
Where'd you meet your wife?
Pilates.
She's European.
Let go.
Just let go.
You have to just let go.
Just let go.
Let's go.
Just let go.
Just let go for the fun. Just let go for the adventure. For the lazy and the crazy times where the ocean meets the sun.
In this sandy white oasis, no matter what your pace is, you can get away, while away, hide away.
You've probably heard a lot about reverse mortgages lately, and frankly, it may all seem just a little confusing. And if you're anything like me, you want to have all the facts before you make any big decision. That's why I want to send you this free DVD about reverse mortgages. It'll walk you through the process, from qualification to counseling to closing, and also answer some important questions. What are the costs, and how do they compare to a traditional mortgage? How is the government involved? And what is your responsibility after you get your reverse mortgage? The answers are all in this free DVD. A reverse mortgage could be a smart, safe, and secure option that could help you pay off your original mortgage, manage your health care costs, or just cover your day-to-day expenses. So call this toll-free number and let me send you your free video right now.
Call 1-800-755-2634.
Today's Big East Network game has been brought to you by PNC, leading the way. By Champion, it's how you play. And by the ESPNU Road to the Championship. Watch the national champion UConn Huskies battle Texas and the Lady Vols of Tennessee battle Texas Tech November 17th in San Antonio. For tickets, visit ESPNUroadtothechampionship.com for more details.
Inside 8 minutes to go in Hartford now. The fans watching their Huskies with the football down by four. Right after this play, John, we got some clarification on that Mike Ryan two-point conversion that was called off and negated. So instead of the two-point conversion, they took the extra point for one.
Well, I'm glad that you got clarification because I cannot wait to hear it.
Okay, okay.
All right.
I understand it now. I was thinking that Ryan had lined up as an eligible receiver. Right after the play now, the I formation, Frazier. Looking up, sidelines, easily, bam, just shy of the 50-yard line. Take another look at this now. He lines up as a tackle.
Yeah, he's right here, but they've got three wideouts here, so they're eligible here. He's covering him, right? So he would be the split end to the wide side. Maybe he didn't line up on the line of scrimmage. Maybe he was off of the line of scrimmage. So I guess they're saying you can't throw a pass to an ineligible receiver because of the alignment.
Well, they said it was a forward pass to a tackle. You can't throw a forward pass to a tackle. That's what the call was. If you would have caught that
behind, which goes back to the argument, was that on the 10-yard line, was that, you know, deemed by
right,
the officials
exactly.
It was forward.
Well, look at this. The Huskies now at the 45, and here comes Todman. And he's driven down. Number 44, Ryan D'Imperio, the leader of that defense, brings him down. 7 minutes to go in the ball game. Down four. Frazier leading that long 82-yard drive. Now he has a chance to pull this one out despite his three INTs.
Well, to start this series, he made a nice throw on the outside to Marcus Easley against that cover two again where the Greg Schiano's cornerbacks are pressing the line of scrimmage and they have a safety on the hash. And he's able to beat the safety off the hash to throw it in that hole. Now facing a third and six. Look for that tight end again in Ryan Griffin.
A lot of players in the box for Rutgers. Here they come. And he swings it out and Andre Dixon. Just too much coverage, too many white shirts. There's been a whole lot that Frazier could have done that time because they were coming on strong.
Well, the best thing that happened there that he overthrew the double coverage because now UConn can punt the football away. They still have three timeouts remaining and plenty of time on the clock at 6:26. But you can't predetermine where you're going to go with the football. That time they had single coverage in the middle on the tight end with pressure coming. So you don't want to predetermine when you've got two guys in white jerseys running out on that wheel route.
That Rutgers player down on the field there, that's Joe Lefege, the strong safety. So he's holding that right leg. And these two teams, as we said at the top of the broadcast, they've had some great battles over the last 6 or 7 years, and we've seen a lot of players get dinged up in this football game.
Yeah, this has been a physical football game. You talk about Cody Endress going out early in this football game. You had Robert McLean, you know, little shoulder injury. And now you've got Lefege on the sidelines.
There he is, number 10, Zach Frazier. One-time player of the year in the state of Pennsylvania. Went to Notre Dame, transferred back here. Ran second string, and that ESPN game against Louisville a couple of years ago, Tyler Lorenzen, or last year I guess it was, Tyler Lorenzen got dinged up and Frazier came in. Then Frazier gave way after an injury to Cody Endress, who was evolving into a very, very productive quarterback here for the UConn Huskies. Endress goes out with a shoulder injury. And Frazier, three INTs, but coming off an 82-yard drive and a touchdown. All season long, Champion Apparel will be showcasing the tradition and history of the Big East Conference. And this afternoon, let's take a look now at the Huskies and the pros. So Donald Brown led the nation in rushing last year. And Orlovsky now down with the Houston Texans, spent his first part of his career with the Detroit Lions. And 11 guys currently on NFL rosters or practice team. The Huskies with 11, the Rutgers 21 this year. Cullen with a high punt. Mohamed Sanu, a true freshman. That's a gutsy catch right there at the 16-yard line. A 30-yard punt. We're going to step away for just 60 seconds. When we come back, 6:19 to go. Rutgers has the ball.
The Ohio State University.
The University of Texas.
Southern University.
California, Berkeley.
Old Dominion University.
Harvard University.
The University of Virginia.
Here, Texas A&M.
Norfolk State University.
Virginia University.
Arizona State.
Pennsylvania State University.
The few, the proud, the Marines.
My new computer started out fast, really fast, but now it's only kind of fast.
Hold on, let me check my email. It's not loading. Let me try this again.
If your computer doesn't run like it's supposed to, if your internet connection is unreliable, even on a so-called fast connection, even if your brand new computer isn't as fast as it ought to be, you might not have any real problem at all. FinallyFast.com free performance test will immediately diagnose any hidden problems and show you how to get more speed on any computer. Plus, FinallyFast.com provides you the software you need to get your computer up to peak performance by getting rid of all the nasty junk files, spyware, adware, and registry errors that make even the best computers freeze and crash. Find out why Ascentive has been featured in Newsweek, Forbes, and the Wall Street Journal. You could save hundreds, even thousands of dollars by taking the Finally Fast performance test first.
I'm booted up. What's that URL I should look at? FinallyFast.com. Hey, my computer's fast. Finally. FinallyFast.com.
Halloween, 2009. And you look at Rutgers, they've won four of their last five on Halloween, and right now lead it by four with 6:19 to go. What kind of plays do you call now, John?
Well, you want to control the line of scrimmage. You want to go downhill running, and that's where they have Joe Martinick in that backfield.
Martinick cuts it back. Well, he doesn't go down very easy. 215 pounds, but he runs a lot bigger. 6 foot 215, the redshirt sophomore. There were 47 plays in the West Virginia game that Randy Edsall pulled off and pointed out to his team that we had a chance to win the game. The defense had the chance, the offense had the chance, special teams had the chance. Now you look back, swirling winds in the stadium today. You look at the two missed field goals by UConn. How big are those now?
Well, they're huge right now, and you take away that two-point conversion as well. You know, there's a lot of plays you can go back and pick out and choose, but right now with 5:43 and counting, you got to make the plays to seal the game if you're Rutgers, but you got to make plays defensively to get your offense back on the field if you're UConn.
In a wildcat formation now, Sanu takes it himself. Look at this. Looks like Jim Brown bouncing off would-be tacklers. Greg Lloyd finally brings him down. A first down, they move to chains. You know, it's funny, the Wildcat, every time Sanu has touched it, he ran the ball. They know what's going to happen.
You know he's coming at you, and he's coming with a whole head of steam, but he's very difficult to tackle at 6'2", 215. The freshman coming out of the backfield, he's terrific when he catches the football in the open field, and he's running with it. But when he's coming in between the tackles, very difficult because that offensive line is creating big seams for Sanu to run through. Four attempts on the afternoon for 19 yards rushing the football. Sanu's done an awesome job at running that wildcat.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line. Sanu out of the wildcat. Lucas is there. Lucas coming off the stingers, and Greg Lloyd also went on the play for the Huskies.
Good job of holding his ground that time was Scott Lutris, and this is the set of downs that UConn needs to go three and out right here. You've got 4:30 left to go in this football game. You've got three timeouts remaining. You want to get a nice stop on second down here and force Rutgers to maybe to an incompletion, or maybe force them to throw or run the football on third down and use one of those timeouts.
There goes Savage now, top of your screen. Mohamed Sanu in the wildcat again. Sanu setting up that option, throws it out of the wildcat, and this is going to fall incomplete. Let's take a look down at our Good Hands Play of the Day, brought to you by Allstate, Tim Brown.
Yeah, Tim Brown, we haven't called his name much, but when we did on the double move, it was good for 6 points. He really set up the beautiful outside and inside, and he gives praise to number six at home here. There he is, number six, his friend from South Florida, Jasper Howard. But a great job by Tim Brown on that double move for 6 points.
Howard from Edison High School, Brown from Northwestern High School in Miami, 1 mile apart. Third and 12 now for Savage. Plenty of time, 4:05 to go. Savage, big play, incomplete, overshoots Brown. And that's going to bring up a punting situation, and Frazier and company will get the football back again.
Yeah, I'm surprised on second down they tried that pass with Sanu trying to go down the field to quarterback Tom Savage, because you could have eaten up another half minute on that clock and then done that on third down. Again, forced UConn to use one of those timeouts because they've got three remaining and an eternity of time with 4 minutes left to go in this football game.
Well, Delagana getting a workout. This is the 10th punt for him this afternoon. He's had a good day. McLean standing at the 29-yard line. Back to the 26. And he's dropped at the 25-yard line. 42-yard punt, a minus two on the return that time for McLean, but a penalty flag is down. We'll wait for the call from Tom Tomczyk.
Holding, 25 on the return team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Well, we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, the Huskies, the least penalized team in the Big East. They've had their share of penalties here today. Penalties, turnovers, but still down only four, 21-17. 3:49 to go. All right, Mr. Quarterback, let's start calling some plays here.
Well, let's start calling some plays. We got to get our playmakers involved, and that's Marcus Easley on the outside. You want to throw the football. You can still throw it to your backs out of the backfield and Jordan Todman, but I'm still saying Ryan Griffin has to be an impact player on this drive or the tight end position, because the middle of the field has been there for the UConn Huskies.
Frazier, wobbly pass, and it's almost complete. Kashif Moore, the intended receiver, it was hanging up there, and it was actually there for the taking, either defensively or offensively, but it falls incomplete. Let's go down to Quinn.
Mike, you can see that pass was not a perfect spiral, and he has thrown the ball right into the heart of about a 20-mile-an-hour wind, and the ball just caught wind and hung up there like a duck.
That's a good point. I'm looking at the goalpost on the far side. Look at the flag. You can see how stiff that wind is. Second and 10 now. Frazier, good time. Stays in the pocket, finds Kunyu for the reception. But it's going to bring up a third down, John, and they're still about 3 yards shy of the first down.
Yeah, that was a good throw because, like Quint said, that ball going from right to left towards that UConn bench is directly into a fierce wind that has picked up in the last 5 to 7 minutes. So it's going to be very difficult to throw in that direction, but a good catch, good concentration by Brad Kunyu to come down with that. Now on third down, you have to convert here to keep your hopes alive.
Frazier steps up in the pocket, feels the pressure. He's not going to get out of bounds. Good job by Rutgers tackling before they could stop the clock. And it's 2:51 and counting now. The clock is moving here in the fourth quarter.
And a timeout used by head coach Randy Etzel after that third down play. Looks like he's just short of the first down.
Their first timeout.
So Randy Etzel and the Huskies using their first of three timeouts here in the second half. And the pressure was good that time.
Yeah, good job on the outside by George Johnson. He was the guy coming from the right side. And then from behind, Jonathan Freeney was able to bring down Zach Frazier a yard short of that first down. But good job by the guys in red helmets and white shirts trying to pressure that pocket, make it uncomfortable for Zach Frazier. He just didn't have enough jets to get outside and move the chains on third down.
See number 99, Jonathan Freeney, a junior from Tampa. 6.5 sacks, third in the league. And it's funny how things work out. Jamal Westerman tore his biceps last year, and Freeney got a lot of reps. It really helped him. Here's a huge fourth down play. Fourth and one, ball on the 22. Frazier under center, eye formation.
And nobody Dixon over the center, Mike.
Dixon behind Anthony Sherman. Dixon gets the call. Dives forward. The spot they had to get to about the 28. Looks like he's closer to the 29-yard line. So that should move the chains, which it does. First down, Huskies.
And that'll stop the clock and allow the UConn Huskies to line up. Get ready for Randy Etzel. This is the ball game right here. This is the drive you're going to win the football game or lose the football game right here.
You know, John, they moved the chains, but they never did stop the clock. The clock kept running. Is that like 2:34? Frazier looking for his man. Unfortunately, too much pressure. Kashif Moore had his man beat inside Rutgers territory. But second and 10 now with 2:16 to go.
Well, credit that front seven, Mike, because they're putting good pressure on the pocket. UConn needs to do a better job of trying to create some time and space for their quarterback to be able to step up into the pocket and hit those open receivers.
Greg Schiano against Rutgers. They had 49 plays defensively, all from the nickel. Frazier fires a drop football and a huge one for Michael Smith.
Well, you got to come down with catches in crunch time, and there's 2:11 left to go. And that time, Zach Frazier did a nice job of moving within the pocket, just slides to his left just a little bit, steps up and throws a strike to Michael Smith. And that may have been good enough for a first down, but he drops the football around the 35-yard line. So now you've got third and 10 with 2:11 left to go in this game.
You can't drop those if you expect playing time next week, huh?
No.
I mean, not at this juncture. 2:11, here we go, third down. Frazier. Smith reaches out. What a catch. Ah, there's some redemption. He's back on the good graces.
In one play, what a catch by Michael Smith, just laying out around the 43-yard line right in front of the Rutgers coaching staff and sideline. Terrific comeback for the sophomore out of Houston, Texas. What a throw by Zach Frazier. Just lets it out, and he's so accurate. That's fingertip
nice
catch.
Nice job cradling it there, huh? 31 yards on the play. Frazier with three picks, but also 275 yards now. That's a career high. They're going to take a look at it, but you're right. I think he cradled it nicely. Charlie Noonan is the down player. Let's take one more look at it here as Noel Turner takes a look at it upstairs.
Nice protection in the pocket for Zach Frazier. There's the fingertip catch. I think he had that right arm underneath the football. I didn't see it move there. We'll take another look here, but just great strength in the wrist and fingertips for Michael Smith to hang on to that football.
Well, the guys upstairs have done a great job looking at the video.
I think he caught the football.
Plays. Let's see what Noel Turner comes up with this time. Could touch the ground, but you're right. I think his arm cradled the ball and protected it from the ground.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed.
Yeah, he had control of the football. That's just a terrific play by a young Michael Smith, only a sophomore out of Houston. That keeps Randy Etzel's team alive with 1:53 left to go in this football game. Only down four, moving it to the 44-yard line. The big guys are smiling.
Keep in mind, first home game since losing their fallen teammates, Jasper Howard. They went to Morgantown. West Virginia was the one team in the Big East they hadn't beaten yet, and they had the lead. And Jared Brown handed the ball to Noel Devine. As soon as he touched the ball, there was 2:18 on the clock, and he broke a 56-yard touchdown run. And that broke the hearts of these Huskies. And now they're trying to get a win for Jasper. 1:47 to go. Frazier fires it up into that wind. Oh, dangerous, dangerous. Dwayne Difton was the intended receiver, but Quint talks about that wind. Are you surprised the way they're throwing it up?
Well, that's the toughest part of the field to throw to, the left side, wide side, because that's where the wind, when Quint spoke about the wind coming from the Connecticut bench, it's ripping from right to left, and it's coming from that Connecticut bench out the end zone to our left. So that's the toughest throw that he's going to make, is from right to left.
Look at the goalposts moving in the wind. Just shaking back and forth.
There's plenty of time left with 1:39. You've got two timeouts. Back to Ryan Griffin. He's reliable on the inside.
Frazier feeling the pressure. Dropped the ball. Still on his feet. Finally goes down. Number 99 putting on the finishing touches. That's Jonathan Freeney. Now just 1:27 to go.
And another timeout taken by Connecticut and Randy Etzel.
Connecticut, their second timeout.
46 yards away from Pater. Down by four. Now let's take a look at our Polaris ORV, hardest working player of the game.
Yeah, Tom Savage has had an excellent afternoon for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. The freshman quarterback has done it all. He's been on the money, down the football field, throwing in adverse conditions. That time to Tim Brown, right down the middle. This time to another freshman in Mark Harrison. So he's done a nice job of moving this offense. And he's 12 of 23 for 155 and two touchdowns. He's hit six different receivers, but it's his poise and his savvy. He's starting to build into that role of a team leader on offense, and you always want your quarterback to lead your team, and he's done a nice job today.
Those two touchdowns giving him five or seven now on the year. Came in with five. There's Frazier out of the gun now. 46 yards away, the big tight end again, Griffin inside the 40-yard line. Clock is running at 1:17, 1:16. Down four, 21-17. Remember, you go back to that two-point conversion. All they would need now is a field goal. But again, they would need it into this wind, this swirling wind. So either way, interesting scenario.
Connecticut, their final timeout. 30-second timeout.
Well, it's a wise timeout because this is the most important play of the game right now.
Please put 1:11 back on the clock.
Down 21-17.
Thank you.
Well, Randy Edsel, right now finishing a fourth down. You take a look at some of the key plays. Devin McCourty, very first kickoff of the game.
Yeah, 98 yards goes Devin McCourty. And really set the tone for Rutgers, doing a nice job of putting points on the board. And then Tom Savage, one of his two touchdown passes to Tim Brown on the outside. But UConn had answers. They did a great job on special teams themselves. Robbie Fry going 100 yards and getting past McCourty around the 5-yard line for a score. But Savage comes back to a young Mark Harrison on the in route, the other freshman on the outside.
Fourth and six, Frazier turns, fires. Kashif Moore has it, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10 inside. Down to the 8-yard line. 63 seconds on the clock.
What a great job by Kashif Moore, the sophomore out of Burlington, New Jersey. Makes a move around the 25-yard line and gets the football down to the 7-yard line with 1:03 left to go. Great throw by Zach Frazier. Just a catch from that shotgun, but he makes somebody miss. Look like may have been Joe LaFage that he makes miss from that strong safety position.
Ryan D'Imperio, the middle linebacker, finally dragging him down inside the 10-yard line.
Looked like Kasim Green pulled a hamstring or had a cramp in that left leg. He's still down for the Rutgers defense, but what a play on the outside by Moore.
Kashif Moore, the young man who held Jasper Howard after he was stabbed, held him in his arms. Kashif Moore said when he got out of high school, he had 5 or 6 days off before heading up here to Stores. First person he met was Jasper Howard.
If you're looking for the love of your life, you could try your luck on dating sites, or you could graduate to eHarmony. eHarmony isn't a dating site. It's a relationship site. We go beyond the pictures and paragraphs to match you on the deepest dimensions of compatibility, like intellect and values, things proven to be the foundation of successful long-term relationships. If you want love, don't settle for a dating site. Go to eHarmony.com. Get started today and review all your compatible matches absolutely free.
See the back pages in a whole new light.
What are you kidding?
As Jonah Schwartz.
That was a very tight game.
And Joe Beningo.
Come on.
Deliver the hottest New York sports topics on Daily News Live, presented by Citi. Weekdays at 5, only on SNY. It's the Jets on SNY. Get all the latest on gangrene with full coverage of Rex Ryan's press conference. Live from Forum Park on Jets Open Mic. Tonight at 6:30, only on SNY.
We welcome you to Geico Sports Night.
Game on.
Here is a huge shocker.
The Yankee fever is on.
This is the right move. We begin at Citi Field.
In Piscataway with the Giants at Yankee Stadium.
Here's Brandon in his weekly chat with our Mike Garofolo.
Will this be your toughest test yet?
That is the sports story in the Big Apple.
And that's the whole enchilada. Always keep it locked right here on SNY.
It's your New York sports here.
That's Dixon in the backfield behind Frazier. Dixon gets the call. Dixon found a little hole inside the five. He's down to about the 2-yard line. 51 seconds to go. No timeouts. Clock is running.
And Rutgers, I'm sure, is going to take their time lining back up.
Timeout. Rutgers, their first timeout.
Well, Rutgers uses their first of three.
Well, they may want to get organized with the ball now on the 2-yard line.
Well, I remember Brian Kelly telling us, we did a Cincinnati game, he said that Rutgers defense, when they have time to set with D'Imperio, they're a very good defense. If you're going to get him, it's usually when they're back on their heels.
Yeah, and you never know if UConn goes in on their second down play, their second and goal play, Greg Schiano wants to still have some time left for his offense to get back onto the football field. So them having such a successful play on first down, gaining 5 yards, you may want to use that timeout in case they go in on second down and you have enough time left on the clock for your offense.
Wild game here in Hartford. Opened up with a 98-yard kickoff return. Robbie Fry of UConn, before going out with an injury, returned one 100 yards. Tom Savage with a couple of touchdowns. Now number 10, Zach Frazier, 3 picks. His career high in yardage, and now he's knocking on the door to become, he could go from goat to hero, as John Congemi pointed out. 49 seconds to go. Here we go. I formation. Sherman, the lead back. That's Andre Dixon with the call. Dixon, nowhere to go. It's that line of scrimmage. Down to 44 seconds.
Timeout, Rutgers.
And once again, the Scarlet Knights calling the timeout.
Yeah, they're trying to keep that some time on the clock in case UConn does score. Now on third down.
Let's take a look. One more peek at the key plays of the game, starting with the opening kickoff.
Well, it all started 98-yard kickoff return. The opening play of the game for goes the distance, and then the freshman quarterback, Tom Savage, found his senior, Tim Brown, on a double move. But that wasn't the only big plays on the special teams. UConn had some up their sleeve as well. Robbie Fry goes 100 yards and a terrific stiff arm inside the 5-yard line that gets him in the end zone. But Savage then hitting another true freshman, Mark Harrison, for a score. The backup quarterback had a little play today. Zach Frazier did a nice job of finding Marcus Easley. Now it's third and goal.
Dixon dotting the I again. Dixon, play action. Frazier fires. Incomplete. 43 seconds to go. We'll be facing a fourth and goal, down 4. The ball resting at the 2-yard line. Last year, the game was 12-10. It was decided on a safety. Blair Bynes found Donald Brown in the end zone.
Well, they're going to bring out Anthony Davis, the fullback, and bring in a couple wide receivers. They're going to go, it looks like, with Anthony Sherman as the only back in front of.
Well, Todman came in.
Todman, yeah.
And Dixon. Play clock running. Here's the call, and it's a touchdown. Huskies, 38 seconds to go.
Yeah.
is so funny, John, because I was thinking when they took Dixon out, I said Dixon seems to be the tougher guy in the tackles. Todman comes in, scores the touchdown.
Well, they get it to that guy that they wanted to run some toss sweeps today and get it outside. This time they spread. They used the stretch play. Nice block.
Sherman.
Terrific block by Anthony Sherman on the crackback out of that fullback spot. Now an all-important extra point.
23-21 Taggart on. He's perfect this year on the PATs. Kick. It's good. 24-21. 38 seconds to go. Rutgers using two of their timeouts during that drive, so they have one left. UConn has no timeouts left. 38 seconds to go. And they can look up into the skies and say, this one's for you, Jazz.
Well, they did a great job of getting the right personnel in on that third and goal play because Jordan Todman, no hesitation, going to the outside in a smart coaching job by Greg Schiano by using his timeouts after that first and goal from the 7. When they got down to the 2, right away, no hesitation, he used those timeouts so he'd have one remaining and give his freshman quarterback, Tom Savage, an opportunity to go down and try to kick a field goal.
Busy Cullen getting ready to kick it off. Husky flag. All the Husky fans here to pay tribute to the junior out of Miami, Jasper. 38 seconds. If the Scarlet Knights can't come up with a score, they'll go to 0-3 moving into the month of November. What kind of kick here as the wind blows it off the tee once again as Cullen will re-tee it up.
That wind again is coming from the top of your screen down to the left-hand side. So it's coming from the UConn bench all the way down to the Rutgers side of the field. So it's going to be a very difficult to get the kick deep enough. They have to cover well. Remember, McCourty. Remember McCourty on that opening kickoff took it 98 yards, so you definitely want to be aware of where he's at.
Both offenses struggling in the first half, but this game has produced some drama. They'll allow number 21, Devin McCourty, to return it. McCourty going down just shy of the 20-yard line. 33 seconds, 11-yard return, so 5 seconds off the clock after the kick from Cullen. Take a look at the numbers by quarter. In the second, 14-7 Rutgers. And then Connecticut, 14 points in the fourth quarter to take the 24-21 lead.
Well, difficult spot for the freshman quarterback to come out. He's got the ball inside his 20 at the 19-yard line. One timeout and 33 seconds left to go. He's got some big play receivers with him. Let's see what he can do.
Savage fires, has his man, Tim Brown. 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Tim Brown. 81 yards. Can you believe it? Oh my gosh, there are some heavy hearts in this football stadium. Jasper Howard's best friend out of Miami growing up. Played against each other just a mile apart. Tim Brown has that 62 tattooed on his bicep. Where's number 2? Jasper wore number 6. Tim Brown said he really wanted to go to the funeral Monday as San Santee kicks the extra point. Said he couldn't make it. He's very disappointed. His mother, 2 sisters, and brother were there instead.
Unbelievable play, and just a great throw by Tom Savage. Plenty of time. He hit Tim Brown right out of the break, just over Robert McClain. And Robert Vaughn didn't have enough in the tank to get to Tim Brown. Just an unbelievable turn of events when UConn went the distance to take the lead. Tim Brown and Tom Savage take it right back.
Tom Savage has a strong arm, John. I mean, there's some swirling winds down there, and he really fired that football. Because even when Brown caught it, he kind of cradled it to bring it in because it was the velocity was.
Well, he drove the football down the hash, and that That's an excellent timing throw, because just as Tim Brown went by Robert McLean, that ball went right past his ear hole. And it's just an accurate throw, strong-armed quarterback, young kid down the middle, taking control of the situation on the first play, the first opportunity for a huge touchdown in his career and bring the score in the favor of Rutgers.
Three touchdown passes for Savage here this afternoon. Tim Brown said this is such an important game for him coming back to UConn. Five catches, 162 yards, two touchdowns. Delegano with the kick now, 22 seconds to go. Todman, Russell down at the 30-yard line, 17 seconds to go. A week ago, they lost by the same score, 28-24. Noel Devine breaking off a 56-yard run. Jerome Jr., the safety, thought he had pushed him out of bounds. Noel Devine, great strength and balance, stayed in bounds and took it to the house for the touchdown. And now, an 81-yard scoring strike from Savage to Tim Brown. And the Huskies are dedicating this game to their fallen teammate, Jasper Howard. Now just 17 seconds to go, 28-24. How do you bounce back from this next week?
Boy, you know, you still got 17 seconds left, and crazier things have happened.
Rutgers
will take their final timeout.
30-second timeout.
You go back, Mike, and you look at the three losses that UConn have by a total of 9 points. You know, you lose on a safety at home to North Carolina. You lose to Pitt on a field goal as time expired. And then you have a 56-yard run last week by Noel Devine with just over 2 minutes remaining in the game. And now you have a pass from Tom Savage to Tim Brown with under a minute left to go in this football game. I don't know if you do bounce back.
Next week they have a trip to Cincinnati. And UConn fans, I said at the top of the show that the script in West Virginia probably not the way they would have written it, the finish. But the fact that it happens again, back-to-back weeks, what are the odds of that? Two 98-yard kickoff returns. 228-24 scores. We'll see if it stands up as the final. 17 seconds to go. Frazier goes to work, finds Marcus Easley at the 40. He's grilled by Ryan DiImperio. No timeouts left. The first down will move the chains and stop the clock with 11 seconds. Frazier spikes the ball with 8 seconds, so 28-24, we're looking at one play.
Yeah, one last play. They're going to have to either throw the football up down the field and maybe get a lateral or get a tip pass, something to happen, because with that wind blowing, it's going to be very difficult for Zach Frazier to throw the football the distance to get it into the end zone.
Here we go, 28-24, 8 seconds to go, last play of the game. Frazier lets it go. Doesn't even get the pass off. Good pressure that time by the defensive front by the Scarlet Knights. Number 99's in there, Freeney. Along with 45, Alex Silvestro, the junior from Gibbstown, New Jersey. But with that pressure, John, that stops the clock now with 3 seconds, so they'll have one last chance.
One more opportunity to get the football down the field. Maybe one of those passes where you want to throw it in the middle of the field where there's a void and maybe get a receiver pitching it back and start that lateral.
Trips to the top of your screen. Frazier fires easily, trying to hook and ladder. Ball's out at the 50, recovered by Rutgers, and that's going to be the ball game. And what a ball game it's been here. Randy Edsel. What he's been through the last 2 weeks to see this happen again. You know, reading some of the blogs, John, on the plane over here, there's one that really stood out. This UConn fan said, you know, my only regret is that it took the passing of Jazz for me to see what a great man Randy Edsel is, the way he handled this the last 2 weeks. And back-to-back devastating losses now.
Yeah, just unbelievable. The turn of events with under 6 minutes left to go. UConn puts on a spectacular drive. They get the ball and take it the distance and get in with under 40 seconds left to go, only for Rutgers and their young quarterback, Tom Savage, to throw a bullet down the field to Tim Brown.
UConn 4-4, 2-2 in the league, and now Rutgers 6-2, 1-2 in the league. Back to wrap things up here after this.